That was a four count.
Are we outside now?
I gotta tell you about that theme song.
Is that public domain? That little intro?
It is now.
Yep. Is it really?
The one we got now is.
Okay.
Because the one before that was.
It was not.
The first video we tagged. Or posted.
Oh, you know. Get that down. They tell you to get it down?
Well, they just said we can't monetize it because it had
We're not monetizing, but...
Goddamn capitalist.
We can't.
Yeah, it had the William Tell Overture on it, but it was like
a copyrighted version.
Oh, okay.
All right. We're here.
Oh, boy.
We're here.
Oh.
All right. That's, episode 15. We're here. Get used to it. So,
we got
a guest here tonight.
Today.
You want to say, well, they can see in the windows. It's dark outside.
I mean, it's not day.
We got some video going.
On an evening.
Yeah.
We're having breakfast for dinner, guys.
Exactly. We're here.
Mm-hmm.
Billy, we're here.
I like breakfast for dinner.
We're queer. But so
get used to it.
Get used to it.
Oh, okay. You'll live your best life.
So the
God damn you, motherfuckers.
So we got Philip here.
Hello.
Philip McClung.
He's here. He's queer.
Get used to it.
Probably a little bit.
Yeah. So that's we're doing episode 15 here at night.
Continental Breakfast Club.
If you want to get in contact with us, email us at thecontinentalbreakfastclub@gmail.com or follow us on Instagram. Get all that out of the way, and then let's get started.
Now we're here again. That was a smash cut on the video.
Yeah. Yeah. That'll be a hard cut. So let's... That was loud. Or do you know what that was? That was a vinyl rip I found. So it's got the hisses and pops.
You said it was loud?
It's loud in my headphones. It was.
Oh.
Yeah. No. Maybe my headphones are cranked up a little loud, but I like it. Let's get these ears ringing. Let's get them ringing.
Huh? What?
Huh? What? You heard this guy, Phil?
Okay, we can stop that, please. That was, that made me, ill, like physically ill. I couldn't continue. I haven't made it all the way through. I couldn't.
Oh, dude, there's an edit of the video that's really funny too. That one where the face shifting thing.
Yeah, it slows down like every time he
gets to like a part where he's like straining, he's like,
yeah,
like it slows it way down and then it fucks his face up on the video.
He really seemed like he was having a stroke, or pooping his pants, possibly.
He should have used a capo, pitch the guitar up a little bit, put it in a different key or something.
Yeah, make it fit your.
Typically,
your
that's
voice.
What singers would do, but
yeah,
nah, man.
No, we don't need that.
Hindsight, 2020.
Dude,
2020. That's a trigger word now. Fucking Christ! Yeah. Enough's enough.
That was a good. Ugh. Yeah. What a year. What a year it is.
Happy New Year's, everyone.
Yeah, yeah. We're celebrating 2021 tonight. Hoping it could be better.
I'm glad that at least the internet is making it through the apocalypse. I didn't think there was gonna be Netflix in the apocalypse, but there has been so far.
Oh yeah. Streaming's nice. Good.
Yeah. No internet outages.
A lot of free time.
Yeah. Lots of free time. Well, not me. I don't know if you guys know, but I was essential the whole time.
Oh yeah, because you essential. Work in the alcohol biz.
I do. Or expendable.
Yeah.
Whatever terminology you want to use.
Yeah.
Man.
Yeah, so. I wasn't. That was hard to swallow. But I was one of the first that got invited back. And I'm still, me and like one or two other people are pretty much the only ones that are still there from the beginning.
When did you
invited back?
When did you actually go back to work?
April 29th.
Oh, wow.
So I had all of April off.
Yeah, that's nice. Mm. What'd you do with your time?
I did this every week. I played a lot of video games.
Yeah.
Yeah, because I got that stimulus money.
Oh, yeah. That's sweet.
That's
sweet government
pretty
cash.
Pretty lucrative, dude, yeah. Being unemployed. So I went on the PlayStation Store, bought a couple games, got Spider-Man. The newer one. Have you played that? Played games much recently?
I play video games, but it's typically like I'll, get done with my day and go home and, hang out with Ashley and whatnot. When she goes to bed, I'll play like a game or two of basketball or football or some shit. I don't game nearly as hard as I used to. The last big game phase I went through was Red Dead. I think like everybody else. And
yeah,
that
was a good one.
I still
played it.
There were times where I figured out a way to get done with my job in like 2 hours on a Friday.
Yeah.
And I would come home and in front of my giant TV set up this like it looks like a lawn chair, but it's not.
Yeah.
It's for inside and it reclines.
Yeah.
And it had a fucking table and shit. And I would sit there. There were multiple times that I sat there for like 16 hours straight.
Yeah.
Like it was fucking insane. And so after that madness was over,
yeah,
I kind of needed a break. I can't do that. That's, I don't know.
I definitely have. I've taken like a long break from gaming for sure. And I have to play. Like if I get kind of worn out now if I play for more than like 3 or 4 hours,
yeah,
which is a long time for most people. Well, I don't know. If
it's
it
still
not
a long
for most
time.
Gamers, but
no, most gamers like I don't know.
That's all
you
they
could
do.
8 or 10 hours easy and not have a problem with
They're
it.
They're shitting in a bucket. Like
yeah,
bathroom.
Yeah,
bathroom mom. Bathroom.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Yes,
that's a baby filling up its diaper.
Well, it's good to see that everyone's growing up. And
it's true.
I love it. That's you get too old for dick and shit jokes.
No,
then
I haven't yet.
I think you're doing something wrong. You know what I mean?
They're always taking your life a little too seriously.
Yeah, a little too much.
Yeah, I agree with that. I like a good fart.
Joke. I do too. I like a good fart.
I do too.
I don't know if I feel like I'm getting gassy with age.
I do. Yeah.
I fart a lot.
Well, I tell you, if you enjoy passing gas, have you drinking kombucha?
I'm not into your crystals, Bill.
No,
or your essential oils. I'm not interested.
Hear me out. There's science behind it.
Okay. Yeah.
There's clinical studies that shows.
Yeah. it's fermented tea, I think. I don't know what it is. It's got a real vinegary flavor, but
I'm immediately not interested vinegar water.
Yeah, I mean,
I'm good.
Yeah,
it's pretty rough.
It's
and some of them have like weird little seed things in it.
I don't like to make myself intentionally fart. I just feel like the older I get, the gassier.
Well, what's nice about kombucha is what they say about it, at least, is that it kind of, it's good for your gut biome. It's got a lot of probiotics in it.
Yeah.
So
the
like,
spice.
So it's like, take your medicine.
Well,
the
so,
spice melange.
Yeah. The spice melange. I'll just kind of drink like maybe one a week just to sort of like reset everything if I've been eating like shit, which I tend to do sometimes.
That
works. It's easy to
have. It does kind of work. And it like sort of, I mean, the 8 or 9 hours after you drink it, though, I mean, it's you're real gassy, but it's like really relieving gas. It's weird. It's weird. Like it has an extra like oh, that felt great getting rid of that. That kind of
sensation. It's not just like a normal fart. They're like, they have like an extra.
It's a fart that feels like a shit.
Kinda, yeah.
It's
So do you shit yourself a lot?
No.
It's a little weird, Bill. I'm going to be all honest.
See anybody else? Anybody? Write us in. Tell us if you like kombucha farts.
Write us?
Yeah, email
like
us.
Send a letter through the mail?
Snail mail?
We're not even going to have a postal service in like fucking 8 months. How are you going to?
Yeah. Listen, FedEx us a letter. I can't even talk. FedEx us a letter, and then we will open it up and read it online.
Yeah.
We'll read it.
We'll do an unboxing video.
Oh, yeah.
Post it to YouTube.
It's just going to be blank sheet of paper with the big fuck you on it.
It's two separate packages. Yeah, fuck you.
Then one's got his kombucha spray in it.
Oh,
sorry, I went there. Sprig. All right, let's punctuate that. So let's. That's enough scatological
humor.
Yeah. We'll come back to it.
You know what would be a good sound drop? Scatman.
No.
I could just sing it.
Skip bop doop ba do bo.
Yeah.
Yeah, dude.
Nobody asked for that. I don't remember asking
flagged
for
copyright for that.
Yeah, I think that was just me paying tribute to it. It should be all right. No, so we also, like that first video, we got tagged for the William Tell Overture, and then we got tagged for the Tina Turner drop, this one.
So are you going to get tagged again?
Maybe. Well, or maybe not, because the second episode we play, or put
up
on YouTube.
Use different sounds.
I know. The second time, I did it out of spite like 12 times, and they didn't get flagged once.
Yeah.
I have no fucking clue how that algorithm works.
So it's all, it's all just some algorithm that goes through, that watches. So basically AI that watches.
Yeah, AI analyzes like
the audio.
Format.
Yeah, kind of.
I mean, it's been like that for a long time.
That's true. Yeah.
It's
kind of what we asked for also.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean.
Like more personalized advertising and shit like that.
Yeah.
Like, I don't want to watch these commercials that don't have shit to do with me.
AI is definitely, and I don't really know shit about the details of how it works, but the idea of it isn't necessarily bad. It's just,
right.
You know, there's a lot of different avenues it could take us, and not all of them are fantastic.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Terminator.
Yeah. Some of them are actually quite the opposite of fantastic.
Yeah, they kind of painted it.
Oh, hey, Glenn.
Brr. Yeah, they kind of painted a pretty picture in Terminator of what could happen.
Barking.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. And that can't be like that far from a reality.
No.
Once it starts, I was listening to something a couple years ago. Sam Harris on his podcast was talking to some AI expert, and they were talking about how think about how quickly a computer learns things. You could give it like all of human knowledge, you know, and it would not only learn it, but as it was learning it, learn how to learn it quicker and quicker and quicker, and it would just grow exponentially. And that's how they think it'll get out of control. Is it'll be like a runaway truck, pretty much. It's like once it's going, you can't stop it. Yeah.
Have y'all watched Devs?
No.
Holy shit. Okay. I can't say anything then. You need to watch I can't say anything. You just need to watch it. I don't want to ruin it for you. It's on Hulu.
Okay.
It's a Hulu original. It's really good.
D-E-V-S?
Huh?
Like Devs?
D-E-V-S.
Okay.
Nick Offerman is like the, he's one of the main characters.
Yeah.
But it's a very, you know, serious role. It's really good. It's pretty, I liked it a lot.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. He's a really good actor.
I like it. Yeah. Yeah. Like he's great. His stand up's pretty good too.
Yeah. Yeah. He's pretty funny. Like, I mean, Ron Swanson's one of the best characters ever on television.
Yeah.
Like, seriously. He's classic.
Yeah.
Nick Offerman was on that movie with Natalie Portman where she was this the astronaut. Did y'all see that one?
I
you know what I'm talking about?
Natalie Portman as an astronaut?
Yeah, she has like a thick southern accent. She has like a short hair.
Not off the top of my head, no.
I don't remember what that is.
Biopic.
A biopic.
A biopic. Is that it? Biopic.
Let's see. I got a fucking tablet here that'll know the answer.
Oh.
To see, yeah, I don't remember what movie that is. We had another listen in Dublin. Fucking.
Or Dublin, or Dublin bloke. Listens.
Got some bloke listening.
Pretty sure that's British accent.
It is.
I don't know.
Pissing him off.
Yeah.
Making him turn it off. He's like, it's not what we. So I was about to do another British
accent. Wow, another.
It's not
just,
what we bloody sound like. That's another, British, dude. Shit.
Another Brit just taking a piss at of the fucking Irish.
Yeah.
Haven't your people done enough to the Irish over the years?
I got some Irish in me.
William Comstock Patterson III is like the most English name I have ever heard in my
entire
life. That is
pretty English. And I definitely... appreciate you saying my middle name.
I love it. I talk to people about your name all the time whenever like
that's getting bleak. Like,
that is pretty regal.
Like yeah, exactly. Like that is I'll tell them that I know this. I'm really good friends with this guy.
Yeah.
Whose name is William Comstock Patterson III, and they're like, "Are you fucking kidding me?" Like, "No, I'm not kidding you at all." And I didn't know that. I didn't know that till I had, man, I had known you for a couple of years before I found that out.
Yeah, I don't really, I don't tell people unless they ask.
Well, too bad. Everyone
and even
knows
I make
now.
A guess. Yeah, typically.
I don't even think you told me. I think you handed me your driver's license.
That might have been it.
Yeah, I don't think you actually told me. I think you handed me your driver's license.
What I used to tell people is that it was like just C, the initial C.
Yeah.
Sneeze. You know, like Harry Truman.
Wait,
I clipped your mic sneezing. That was impressive. You know, like Harry S. Truman.
Yeah.
His middle name is that initial. It's not a name. It's S.
I never knew that.
Yeah. So I used to.
That's
whenever
fucking
I figured
weird.
That out.
What the fuck kind of?
I know.
Just don't give. Just don't put a middle name in there.
I know.
Don't just. I don't like that at all. I don't.
Yeah, there's movies. So I just used that. Well, as soon as I figured that out, I was just like, "Oh fuck it, I'm just gonna go by. I'll just tell everybody it's just C." And then
Lucy in the Sky is the name of that.
Oh,
movie.
I was looking right at that, but I didn't see it.
I mean, it's really just Billy.
But Nick Offerman is in that.
I mean,
movie.
Do you even introduce yourself as your full name in a business setting?
No.
Do you? Because I remember. I don't know how old we were, but I decided I was going to call you Bill.
Yeah.
Because Billy was a kid's name.
Yeah.
Do you ever introduce yourself as Bill now that you're old as fuck?
No.
Okay.
No, I don't. And I'm actually junior, so I'm a second.
But I thought you were the third.
No, but third does sound more
regal.
We'll
make it
for sure.
Backslashing's fourth to fifth.
Yeah. Yep.
Well, now I feel like I've told people that you were the third.
That's fine, though. The third is, it definitely.
That's regal as fuck.
It's better, yeah.
That puts it over the top.
It does.
So the part that put it over the top was a lie.
Wow. Totally, yeah.
I am a piece of shit.
You've been living a lie.
Just gotta, you know.
Congratulations.
For the sake of the story, it's fine.
Yeah.
Yeah. A little white lie.
Just
never
stretch
hurt
it up a little bit. Yeah. No big deal.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Put the little line over the E.
Exactly.
Like deer tame.
Yeah. Yeah. Don't church it up. It's dirt. Fucking love that movie.
Oh, man.
That was a very, very. That movie was a surprise. Joe Dirt.
Yeah. I still haven't seen the sequel, but I really want to.
I haven't either.
It's worth a watch, but.
Yeah. Really?
It's not.
It's not. I know what it's not going to be.
Yeah, I mean, you should never expect that. But yeah, it's.
Yeah, I've seen plenty of comedy sequels to know that they're not going to be that good. But they might be kind
of
good.
And a lot of the time they come because, not because the people that did the first movie want to do a second, but because the fan base just calls for it so much for so long. Like, I've talked to you about this before. I might have talked to you about this before, but big Strangers with Candy fan.
Oh, I mean, I've seen a bunch of it. I haven't talked to you about it.
And then Strangers with Candy is beyond its time. It was like late 90s, early aughts on Comedy Central.
Yeah.
And just, you know, unafraid to say anything and made really, I mean, it was really, really good, like, social satire shit. But the show got canceled after, like, I think it was 3 or 4 seasons, something like that.
Mm-hmm.
I never knew why. I always kind of figured it was because it was too racy at times. But, or at least for, you know, mainstream audiences of the time.
Yeah. Like,
but then, like, it was fucking, I want to say it was like 8 years later, maybe 10 years later. Strangers has a huge hardcore like cult following.
Yeah.
And the fan base just clamored for years to get a fucking film made. Yeah. And made a film. And the film is fucking terrible. It's all like, because they didn't want to, that wasn't their idea. Like they didn't want to make a movie.
Yeah.
And so it was just all a bunch of recycled jokes from the show. And
it was
kind of a bad way to remember the series. I wish they would kind of want to just left it.
Yeah.
But the fucking fans asked for it. They asked for it and
they didn't
get what they wanted, but they got something.
Yeah. Sometimes you can't can't capture the magic again.
Yeah. That's fine.
It's,
Anchorman 2.
Yeah, that's a perfect example.
Buddy. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, that's why a lot of really good comedies like kind of stand alone just because they're...
Yeah.
There was only one. And it's like they could have made another one because it was so popular, but it's like, no, we don't want to fuck this up.
The Hangover 2.
Yeah.
The Hangover 3.
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
Fully hungover.
Oh, man.
I got a migraine.
Really hungover.
I never saw those movies. Or I saw the first one.
The first one was good.
Yeah, it was.
It's
a good concept.
It was just the same shit.
Yeah. Except more extreme because they didn't outdo themselves.
Yeah, they just had more Mountain Dew in the script.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You can't put,
fucking extreme
shit.
You
can't put out the same movie twice, you know?
Yeah. That's another problem with doing those sequels is like that you have to outdo the first one. Or you have to attempt to outdo the first one, and sometimes it just comes off like, this is just too crazy. Like, it doesn't make any sense. Like,
yeah.
People wouldn't do that. Those characters wouldn't do that.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think they're too invested in what happens with the characters and what they would or wouldn't do. They're just like, let's make another hit movie.
Yeah. Yeah.
We don't need writers. We already got a movie.
Let's, right. So I just need somebody to write on my check.
Goddamn.
Oh, I need a cha-ching on here, dude.
Yeah.
That's probably got some sort of fucking copyright on it, too. The Michael Jackson's estate owns the copyright to the fucking cash register sound.
Yeah, the cha-ching.
So how do y'all feel about that shit? Have y'all ever talked about that on a podcast before?
What? Copyrights?
Like, I don't know, like, all the shit that's come out about Michael Jackson and, like...
Oh.
All the...
Yeah. I kind of honestly, like, I'm remaining...
The diddling
stuff. The diddling,
The diddling. I'm totally willfully remaining ignorant. I don't want to see that new documentary.
Oh, you haven't seen it?
No.
I saw a part of it where...
It's pretty disturbing.
I know.
I've
heard all about it, but
yeah,
I don't know. I have a,
there's also a lot of shit from the other side where I don't know, man. I've always kind of thought, and whatever it is, maybe I'm judging them.
Yeah.
You know, but I always kind of thought Mike was weird, and it seemed,
oh yeah,
it seemed appropriate that it made sense to me that he would do something like that. But maybe that's just because of what I was,
yeah,
you know, the information I was given. So.
And he's definitely a weird dude, or was. And
I think he made some great music, though.
Fuck yeah.
Can I just say that?
You know, man, I still don't really care for any of the like latter day Michael stuff, but there were a lot of good tunes. And
so if you were good in the 70s,
the Jackson 5
album that really sucked and nobody liked it. But if you're good in the 80s, that's kind of what the 90s were.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I don't take a lot of those kind of albums, the later albums, seriously either.
But right.
Yeah.
Yeah. That,
I can't help it. Come on. You can't help but like that song.
Yeah, I mean, the whole album, Off the Wall album, and, I mean, obviously Thriller. Like, every single song on Thriller is amazing. One of my favorite songs of all time is on Thriller, Human Nature.
I don't know if I know that. I haven't listened. If I don't know it by name. I haven't listened to Thriller in,
it's,
I don't even know how long.
I would play it, but since we're video and fucking YouTube.
Well, just kill the video then. And
yeah.
Or here, we could
probably. Well, we can't. We'd have to like cut it out of the YouTube video and put it in.
Yeah.
Or I could just mute it on the track here. So we don't have to listen to the whole song. I just want to. You'll know it like the minute you hear it. It's got a really great intro. Where's my music on here?
How's music.
That accent, guys?
British guy?
Yeah, was that good? Oh, that's right there.
I thought it just sounded like a regular guy. It's a non-dialect, or what is that called?
Accent?
Yeah, non-region-specific dialect.
Oh, yeah.
There we go. Like news anchors. Maybe it's a little British. I don't know.
Maybe.
Looking out across the night, the city winks asleep as I. Yeah.
I don't know.
You like it?
No, nah, not really. That's not. Dude, that's not really my thing.
Can't help it on there.
I just, but maybe it's also in my head. I mean, the second I heard him start singing, I just thought about someone molesting little kids. I don't know. That's what happened.
That's why Billy won't.
That's why I won't watch the documentary.
Yeah.
I'm afraid it'll ruin him.
It's gross.
I mean, yeah.
I saw the.
I can infer what happened.
There was a guy talking about how Michael Jackson put a finger in his butt.
Yeah.
What is it again? I can't wait.
They said, one of them said that he liked to have them bend over and spread their butt cheeks apart. And he would just look at their buttholes.
Hold on.
That's real strange.
We heard the stories, dude. Listen to the music.
Now listen to this music.
He put out an album called Dangerous. Everybody should have known.
Now listen to this music.
Should have known he was dangerous.
Yeah, exactly.
Should have known he was off the wall.
I can't help it. Ooh. I do like that. Rhodes in there. Ooh.
Can't you like it just a little bit?
Yeah, YouTube won't be able to hear this. That means I'll have to bounce it twice, so fuck. I can't help but see you.
Early Mike's voice was just
pretty good.
So buttery, man.
That's pretty good.
Yeah.
I just gotta like block out the kids. Yeah. I gotta block out the kids.
Yeah.
Is that too much?
No, that's
not
a bad...
Going too hard on Michael Jackson?
That's actually not a bad strategy in life.
Listen, man.
What, to block out the kids?
Fuck the kids, okay?
Wow. I believe the children are our future.
Michael Jackson sang on that song.
He did. He was a big collaborator on that song.
Yeah.
It's
a good way to meet kids.
I really gotta say, I do kind of, I don't know, some of the younger generation, I think they get a bad rap, but
Yeah.
I don't know. I think they're...
I think some
for better or worse, I think they're real active. I think they're real engaging for sure. And, you know, try to push conversations forward a lot of the time. I think especially with... I feel like a lot of the... You know, we were talking about earlier, like, you know, cancel culture shit. And all that stuff is... I feel like that's more from maybe ours and a little younger than ours age group, like millennials and stuff.
Right. It is.
But I don't know. I mean, I don't have a lot of 21-year-old friends and shit. Right. So. Yeah.
It is a lot of that age bracket. Like,
it's what it
19
seems like.
To 24-ish, probably. They're the... Because, I mean, they're in college.
Yeah.
You know, you go to fucking college. It's the first time you're by yourself.
And really, to like you just, form your own opinions.
Yeah, you can form your own opinions. You don't have to fucking pretend you're something you're not, you know, finally.
Yeah.
If you were doing
if
that.
If you did have to do that, to survive whatever high school or home life was for you.
Yeah, exactly. So I think they just, you know, they get on their own. And when you're young, I mean, that seems legitimate. Like if somebody says something I don't agree with, they should be silenced.
Yeah, fuck you.
Yeah. Don't ever.
I
never ever think you should ever say that again. It's like, okay.
I get how you could get there.
I do too.
But I also think that you're going down a bad path.
Right.
When you try and cancel everything that doesn't fit your worldview. And then we get into this shit where we just keep moving further and further apart as a fucking species.
Yeah.
You can't have a fucking conversation with somebody after you fucking silence their voice.
Exactly.
It doesn't make any sense to me. I get the emotional response. I totally do.
Yeah.
But I think it has a negative impact for sure.
I mean, I even get like, you know, kind of the safe space mentality where it's like, you know, you just want shit around you that's going to make you happy and not fucking stressed out. That being said, I kind of do that consciously with myself. You know, I try not to do shit that stresses me out. You know, sometimes it's just inevitable, but I think that, you know, I don't go around trying to force my safe space on everyone else around me. It's like, it's my own personal thing.
Well, and you got to realize where that can and can't be. Like it probably can't be out in public because the world's just not there to bend to your will all the time.
Right.
But I mean, I don't get out a whole lot. Yeah. I enjoy being home around the things that I have and, you know, playing instrument. I would rather play an instrument than talk to any human being. I mean, that's kind of, I don't know. That's how I've always kind of felt.
No, I know that feeling.
So there are places where you can have that space. Mm-hmm. I just don't know if you can expect it everywhere that you go. Even virtually, like you can't expect that to happen.
Oh yeah.
The world is not necessarily no if, ands, or buts about it. Like the world is not a nice place.
No. And there's always going to be assholes.
It's not easy. Yeah, there's a lot of obstacles and a lot of horrible shit that happens, but
yep. Yeah, there's always going to be dicks.
Yep. But dicks fuck assholes, Chuck.
That's right.
And if dicks didn't fuck assholes, then your pussies would be covered in shit.
Exactly. Yeah. Well, if a dick fucks a pussy long enough and hard enough, the pussy will become an asshole.
Listen here, Chuck. Fucking Christ. That's
one of the greatest fucking speeches of all time.
The first time I saw that movie, I saw it in theaters on acid.
Same.
Oh, no, and I was rolling, like fell out of my chair at one point.
Laughing.
It was fucking priceless. Fucking
Christ.
Yes.
Dude, so when the first scene opens up and it's the shitty Eiffel Tower drawing and there's like a puppet and you're like, is this what the movie's gonna be like? And I was like, what the fuck is this? And
then it
pans out and it's like a puppet doing a puppet on the street.
So
and you're just like,
I had a friend point something out to me that I had never noticed in all the number of times that I've watched that movie. In that opening scene where it pans out.
Yeah.
You look at the street.
It's croissants.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or baguettes or something. Some sort of bread. Is it croissants?
Like the croissants. Roads made out of them?
Yeah.
No, yeah, yeah. Well, yeah, it's like all the cements, like blocks or whatever, they have like a emblem on it and it's croissants.
Oh, that is such a fucking Trey Parker Matt Stone thing to do.
It's that movie is... It was a real masterpiece.
Yeah, it really is.
It's really good.
Dude, yeah.
It's got a lot to say that is still really
super
applicable.
Relevant, so.
Very, yeah, absolutely.
Yeah,
holds up well.
America is still doing the same fucking shit that we were doing in 2004, man.
Dude, we might talk about this before, but remember that movie, The Interview?
Yes, yeah. That was amazing.
It was Team America Part 2.
Yeah,
basically.
Yeah.
Like, Team America did everything that The Interview...
I really liked The Interview.
As far as, like, making fun of North Korea and stuff like that.
Yeah.
But it was just his dad, and I guess his dad didn't care that much.
Yeah. I'm so Ronery.
Oh, yeah, they did. They did ban that, right?
Yeah, I didn't get to come out in theaters because North Korea was all huffing and puffing about it.
Yeah, that's right. Ooh, another movie that I saw recently. Sorry, this is kind of on a different track, but I had someone put out a recommendation for this movie that was supposed to be talking about cancel culture shit. It was supposed to be put out in, I believe, May or April of last year. Called The Hunt.
Oh yeah,
heard
about
that?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
So it's like rentable now.
Yeah.
And it's fantastic.
I haven't even heard of it. What is that?
It's got a political charge to it.
So it does, but it is a total satire on all these people who live there. Or like fixated on political affiliation and shit like that on, particularly shit that has to do with social media.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
It's really good. It's like a modern day political satire, but it's like a gore horror kind of, not horror, but it's fucking bloody and violent and, it's really good. It got the release got postponed because it was supposed to. It was right after that fucking, was it the Walmart that got shut up?
Yeah,
in El Paso, I think.
Yeah.
And there was another incident before then where there was like a politically charged like right wing like terrorist attack on.
Yeah,
you know, I forget because the one in El Paso was directed at Hispanics.
Yeah.
I forget what the one was right before that, but because of that, the movie studio that was going to release it decided to hold off.
Yeah. Bad timing.
Of course, I don't know why they're making it available to fucking rent right now. It's not any fucking better right now.
Yeah. No, yeah, it's actually a little worse.
It probably is. But honestly, I think...
still got to make the money, though.
I think, I don't know. The
investments were made.
Need to watch it. It's really good. I think it's something that we all need to watch right now because it pokes fun at everyone who gets, you know, super outraged and, like, full of, like, self-righteous indignation on the internet, which is pretty fucking rampant on all sides. And it pokes fun at all of those people.
Yeah.
And I think everyone should fucking watch it right now.
Yeah.
Like the hero is this apolitical figure that is constantly caught in between both sides. It's pretty cool.
Yeah.
It's worth a watch. I watched it,
check it out,
three times in 48 hours. It's it was that good.
Yeah.
I was really, really impressed. It's like, you know, it's a satire, so there's a comedic aspect to it.
Yeah.
And it's It's really good. It's really well written. The acting's really good. The protagonist is what is her? She's in Glow. Have y'all watched Glow?
Yeah,
Alison Brie.
No,
the blonde one.
The one that is her nemesis. The one that's like the
American girl.
The American girl.
Yeah, the blonde one.
I
don't know her name.
I don't know her name either.
I know you're talking about though. Yeah, Glow is good too.
Glow was good.
I just watched Glow to see Alison Brie's moves. That's the only reason.
So you tuned out like after.
Well, Ashley was watching it, and I watched it.
Yeah.
I have this.
It's a good show.
Unless,
man.
Well, I have this problem. So unless something that we're watching is like super duper captivating.
I was saying this last night.
I'm on my cell phone, especially over the last like, you know. Fuck since March, yeah. You know, the last 3 months, because I just have this constant desire to see what the fuck is going on in the world.
Yeah.
And it, you know,
it's rough sometimes.
It's yeah.
But Alison Brie's boobs could get you.
Alison Brie's boobs, caught my attention for sure.
Yeah. The, dude. Yeah. She is, I fell in love with her on Community.
Same.
See, I watched the first, I think, season or two of Community, and I'm not for any particular reason, kind of lost touch with it.
Yeah.
Man, that's good.
Yeah.
That's a really good show.
It goes pretty out there, too.
Yeah.
They start doing, like, themed episodes almost.
Okay.
Yeah. Did you see any of the paintball episodes?
Mm-mm.
Yeah, those are really good.
It's pretty much like the season finale of every season, or like of the first few seasons, couple seasons, I guess.
They'd have like a giant.
I think it doesn't happen until like the third or fourth season.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. But they did like three or four of them.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
And it's always like a big deal. Like they have some paintball war on campus, but they do it themed. Like one was like water world kind of. Like they couldn't touch the ground. Then it was like a floor is lava sort of thing.
Yeah.
That wasn't a paintball episode. But then they had fuck.
They've done like a Western.
Yeah, Western one. They did a video game kind of one where it was like,
future. I think they did like a sci-fi one, maybe. I don't know. I might be wrong, but yeah, they're just it's like everybody, it's like the school shuts down, and it just becomes like a 24-hour paintball contest.
And it's usually for like priority.
It's like the purge kind of.
Priority registration. So they're like, I get to pick all my classes. I can have all my classes on Monday.
Yeah.
Like the purge, but like nobody dies.
Right. It's all paintball. Mm. But like they mock dying and like getting shot. Like, blah, 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 you know.
Okay.
Or,
you gotta, if you're gonna do any kind of war reenactment or paintball stuff, you should. I appreciate the people that take time to die properly.
Me too.
And not just like fall down and be an idiot.
Yeah. Or like get
well,
hit.
I guess I know. Hamming maybe I shouldn't say that. Because there are plenty of people that, just in war, just kind of fall down.
Yeah, that's true.
I guess that is realistic, but
yeah,
it's not entertaining.
No. Right.
That would.
I like them to act it up, I guess.
I was going to say that would make a. War more entertaining, you know, if there was.
God damn it! No.
It's like, are you shot? No, it's just practicing.
I mean,
for when I get shot later.
I mean, there is though that does happen.
Yeah,
but they're not acting.
That's true. speaking of that of war, I actually have a guy I went to high school with. He was I didn't know he was in SEAL Team 6. For like the last 15, 16 years or something like that.
Yeah.
And he just put out this book. And I guess I haven't read it, but it's all about like his time as a SEAL team member.
Okay.
I've got a lot of, he went to our high school. I've got a lot of high school friends who have read it. They say it's pretty crazy. But yeah, the, I don't know why I just, interjected that, but you know, check it out.
okay,
I think it's called Mob 6.
Mob 6.
Okay,
mm-hmm.
It's supposed to be really good. Like, if you like reading about like soldier memoirs and stuff like that. Have y'all ever read anything like that?
I went through a period of time where I studied a lot about the Civil War that I've forgotten all of at this point. But
yeah,
I read this.
Not since then. I don't know, man.
It is pretty. I mean, there are parts that are hard to read.
Yeah,
for sure.
I mean, war is fucked up.
I just like reading how like these, like the guys deal with it.
Yeah. You know?
Like when they.
Or don't.
The first one I ever read was called Memoirs of an Elite, or Memoirs of a SEAL Team Sniper, I think, or something like that. And it's this guy named Howard Waston, and he was on the SEAL team, and during the Battle of Somalia or Mogadishu, you know?
Yeah.
Whenever all that shit was going down, like in the early 90s, he was in that battle, like Black Hawk Down. He was a SEAL team member at that, like when that movie took place.
No shit.
Like that whole, that's called the Battle of Mogadishu. He was a SEAL team member at that battle. I don't know if anybody plays his part in the movie or anything, because I don't think that, because there was a lot of like Army Rangers and soldiers there, but I don't think any of them really knew that the SEAL team was there. But they were just kind of, it's crazy. There's a part where he's talking about how since the communications were so shitty back then, he had been shot, I think, like in the hip already, and he was trying to. He had two guys in like a Jeep who had already been shot and were dying, and so he's just trying to leave and like find like a, you know, just get like a mile outside of the thing to either drop these guys off or find a medical tent or something, you know. And he kept getting directions from the radio guy who was like miles and miles away, who was trying to watch it through like an old school like satellite feed that had like a 20-second delay on it.
Oh, well, that's
so
not,
the video that,
that's
yeah,
not great.
No, yeah. So he's like, Where am I? Where do I need to go? And he wouldn't hear anything. And then like 20 seconds later, he'd hear, turn right. But he was already
way the fuck past where he needed to turn right.
And so like he was like, I just had to keep turning around and driving through this fucking battle with, you know, me being shot. He ended up getting shot like two more times, just like driving through. And he was like, it was the most frustrating thing in the world because I was completely lost. I had two dudes screaming in the back. There's fucking artillery going off everywhere.
Yeah.
The helicopter crashed and everything. I mean, it was complete and utter chaos. Like the whole village was pretty much.
Why were we there in the first place?
I have no idea. I think it was. It might have been like a dictator situation or something. Like we were just doing what we do as Americans and kind of butting in.
Yeah, policing the world.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
World police.
Oh,
exactly.
Okay. So just another one of those imperialist tactics that we like to use. Cool.
There's probably diamonds or oil or some sort of resource.
Definitely some sort of resource for
that
us
we
to
now
take
probably
advantage
have,
of.
Yeah. That we now have like a in
cool.
on, you know, we're like,
yeah,
sweet.
That's fucking great.
Thank God we fucking went over there to Somalia.
Fantastic.
Or no, it was, I think it was some, I think there was like a leader who, was committing a bunch of like human rights violations, and I think a lot of people in Somalia were starving and dying of disease and shit. And I think we went over there to help, and I think it turned sour because I think we tried to assassinate somebody or kill somebody or something, and it backfired. And I don't know all the details
that
of
happens.
The yeah it's like a power vacuum sometimes
yeah. So we had one dictator, now we have, you know, eight warlords that are all horrible themselves that are now running the same area. Okay, cool, good job America. Way to go.
And they'll never stop fighting.
No.
Because it goes back generations and generations. Like my grandfather hated your grandfather.
So we got to hate each other, right?
Exactly.
Mm. That's getting us a lot of places. God damn it.
Yeah. So, you learn something new every day. You know, that's what I like to say.
Did you learn something? I don't think we learned anything there. We already knew this.
I sat here and told you how I didn't know what caused the Battle of Mogadishu.
Yeah. It's just America being the fucking imperialist bastards.
I looked it up. It was the Mohammed Farah Adid was the warlord that basically everyone was following over in Somalia.
Okay.
You remember every time I hear Warlord, I always think about this. That Saturday Night Live skit with Phil Hartman.
Yeah.
Where he's Bill Clinton.
Yeah.
And he's at the McDonald's and he's talking about what's happening whenever we're sending aid to these countries in Africa and why we need to send troops over there. Because he's like, we send this to this village. Say this, he picks up this guy's food and he's like, say this is what we're sending to these people over here. And he picks up some chicken nuggets and he's like, and then here comes this warlord and he eats a bite. And he's like, and this warlord takes another piece and he eats a bite. He's just fucking eating these people's food, trying to justify sending troops into Africa.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, man.
Well, he was also, that was a huge thing whenever Clinton was in office. He was like going on these, like, publicity jogs.
Oh yeah,
he'd always
end
up at McDonald's.
Yeah,
he was just jogging at McDonald's.
You know, man.
Which I mean, whatever. I mean, at least he's jogging, but
like he's not as much of a fat piece of shit as everyone else that drove to McDonald's to eat there.
Hey, I get it delivered, dude. So.
Yeah, no, same. I've had same. If you don't, I never really did the Uber Eats thing beforehand.
Yeah.
But I started doing it.
Sorry to see the light a little
during more. during the pandemic, during the end times.
It's convenient.
Where there was, you remember when there was no toilet paper, guys?
I did,
yeah.
Because people thought that they were going to poop uncontrollably. I guess weeks and weeks on end, even though there was absolutely zero.
I asked.
It wasn't even one of the symptoms.
not even close.
I asked where the hand sanitizer was at a store one time because I was trying to get some, and they were like, we don't have any.
And I was like, go okay. Fuck yourself. Yeah. Dude, it was crazy. I was working in, so when all that shit happened, obviously, I work in on-premise, like bars and restaurants as a sales rep. And when that happened, they moved all of us to go work grocery stores doing merchandising, learning how those sales reps work and I covered for one for a couple days. I did a horrible job. I had no idea what I was doing. It's a totally different thing.
Yeah.
But it was wild to see those first 2 weeks after, they shut everything
shelves,
down.
Nothing on them.
Bare shelves all over the grocery stores. Fucking the guy that I was assisting on his route, helping do put-ups, I would ask him, like, how much, what's normal for this time of year? And he's like, basically, you're seeing us do what we would do on a 4th of July or Memorial Day weekend.
Wow.
Every fucking day. It was like that. He was sending in like 2 to 4 times as much during that period of time. And now we've run into all kinds of issues. Like we're out all kinds of different products and shit. We ran out of fucking Miller Lite and Coors Light kegs.
Yeah.
The Bud distributor in Austin has run out of Bud Light kegs now. Yeah. Like everybody is running out of all kinds of shit.
Dude, we're out of recording interfaces completely.
Because China's been open for a while now, though.
They haven't been exporting a shit ton of stuff. I think they've been exporting, like, essential things. Food, I guess. I don't know what food we get from China. I'm not going to say. That'd be
Chinese food?
Yeah. That's true.
Yeah. What else? I mean, what else do you want?
Nothing. I was
trying to think of something really odd.
Story checks out.
I mean, there's maybe it doesn't.
There's a
that guy Carl Pilkington, you know, the Ricky Gervais and Steve Merchant's friend.
Yeah, that's
the idiot abroad guy.
That dumb motherfucker. God damn it.
He was talking about China, and he's like, I like Chinese food, but you go to China and I mean you go to a restaurant and you're like, yeah, I'll have some breakfast, and they're like, all right, here's a squid bullock.
It's breakfast.
Yeah.
Of champions.
Yeah, right.
Just dude, pop on. Some of that, I'm sure y'all scroll squid through bullocks, fucking right. videos and shit and see like a lot of the Asian street food breakfast stuff.
Yeah.
With like eggs and chives and tomatoes and shit on like flat grills, and they just throw the buns on top or maybe put some cheese in between and then smash the buns together and just shit looks fucking delicious.
Yeah.
Getting hungry just thinking.
Yeah, I should have got more than just that Big Mac.
I thought you were gonna
more like a medium Mac. Huh?
Like the eggs with like the baby birds in them.
Oh.
Not interested in all that. I don't need
that.
It's
like a delicacy.
I know.
I mean, I'd try it once. If it was delicious, maybe
I would try it
some more. I'll try any food once.
I'll try anything once.
Absolutely.
Too.
Yeah.
You do if that. I hate it, I'll never eat it again.
Right.
But I'll try it once. Yeah.
All right, guys, I'm going to make y'all some shit sandwiches. You just got to try it.
Well,
you got to try these things, too. They're good. They're great. Wow. You got to try it. Come on.
Okay.
This is a Second Harvest sub.
Second Harvest. That's fucking disturbing.
That's what
Second Harvest.
Yeah, that's what they call it whenever, like, if you're in the wild and they say you're like stranded out in the wild,
you eat berries and
go
stuff
find like bear shit and dig berries out of it.
Yeah,
because they don't fully digest them because they eat so many.
I mean, I'll find food elsewhere.
I would try elsewhere for sure.
I'll go fishing or
figure
something.
Out where the bear got the berries.
Okay, wait. If you guys are stranded, how long would it take before you're drinking your own piss, though?
A while.
I don't know. I don't.
What if it's like a desert situation? How long before you're drinking piss?
I
to save your life.
I wouldn't hesitate.
I don't know if it would save your life.
So you're like,
I mean,
1 hour
maybe
in.
I don't know.
1 hour in, you're drinking piss.
I think if you're taking in a lot of toxins, if you're drinking your urine without like
it's
boiling.
It's super salty too.
How do you know?
Well, I've heard. No. God damn it.
You've heard, huh?
I've heard that it's salty. Like that's one of the things that you expel in urine is salt.
Sucked it out through a hose. Huh?
All right.
Yeah.
Thought it was a hose. That...
You just had to close your eyes and suck it through a hose?
Huh. Yeah.
Okay.
No, yeah. No, that's... Yeah, I don't know if I could do that. Like, I don't know if I could do
that. If I had a means to like...
Distill it?
Run it through the machine that Kevin Costner had in Waterworld?
Exactly.
Immediately.
Dude, you're in the opposite of Waterworld. You're in the desert.
In dry world.
You're in dry world, yeah.
I don't know. I would just try not to pee, honestly. I would try to keep all the liquids inside of me that I possibly could.
Me too. You can make a urine still. I've seen that on TV.
So you just basically boil it. And
yeah, you take like some plastic, find some plastic and you fucking like dig like a little hole, pee in it. And then cover it with more plastic.
And then collect the condensation off of it.
Yep.
Yeah.
And it'll kind of like evaporate all the,
it's pretty smart.
Condense all the fucking water out of it.
Piss MacGyver.
I bet that fucking concentrate though, after you lift that thing up. Oh.
Then you huff that and then.
Yeah.
Oh, come on. God damn it.
Oh, dude, I got a better one.
Don't do it.
All right. I'll
don't
want
to. No, do it.
Just do it.
We're already here. Might as well do it.
I agree. This is good.
That's way too long. No one ever needs to hear that ever again.
Oh, dude, we do that probably like once an episode.
No.
No. That's one of my favorite sound drops.
Why?
I don't know.
Why?
This is a good one. This is him like right afterwards whenever somebody asks him if he's okay.
Don't worry about it, bro.
What the fuck is that?
Don't worry about it, man.
I just searched best vomit ever on YouTube.
And it was a video, but it wasn't, you couldn't even see anything. It was just like, it was like somebody's phone was in their pocket. It might've been his, I don't even know. But like, yeah, it's like a 30-second video.
Dude,
and he does that, and somebody's like, are you all right, man? He's like, don't worry about it, bro.
I don't need to.
What if you woke up one morning and you had that on your phone and you didn't remember anything and you're like, man, I got fucking wasted last night.
Yeah.
What's this?
Yeah. Yeah.
That's terrible.
A text from your friend. Don't worry about it. Yeah. All right. So let's, Bill, you said you brought some notes.
No. You're going to put me to work.
We could turn this ship.
I don't know, man. So this shit is
crazy.
Heavy. Like, yeah, this, what's been going on,
yeah,
not just in the past, like 2.5 weeks, but really since the beginning of March has been a lot on the forefront of everybody's mind. Like, this is. But I do, in saying that, though, if I hear one more person say, in these uncertain times, any kind of whatever adjective fucking times you, yeah, we know it's fucking crazy. Yeah. Like, we're living it too.
Yeah.
Get it. That's enough. I don't need to hear anybody say that anymore.
Exactly.
But,
yeah, man, in these trying times.
Fuck you, dude. But no, it's, man, I don't know. There's a lot, and we talked about some of it earlier, so we don't, you know, we can maybe talk about some things that,
yeah,
to kind of, you know, expand on that. But yeah. I did want to talk to you about something though first. Like, so I really just came here to call you a racist.
Yeah.
That's why I'm here. That's because that's what we're doing right now. I'm here for the sole purpose of calling Billy. In particular, racist.
All right. Well, let's try and...
But no, so the whitest thing I heard, I had some things I want to talk about your last podcast, and the whitest thing I maybe have ever heard anyone say, I heard you say.
All right.
When y'all were talking about was it the birds that were going in and out of the bush?
In
and out of the bush?
Yeah.
And you referred to one of them as a biggin, and you called it a 6-incher. I just wanted to let you know, Bill, that that's really just average, sir.
Dude, come on.
I thought that was the widest thing that I've ever heard anyone say.
Dude, it was huge. It was like 6 inches.
There for a second.
It was the biggest thing that my girlfriend had ever seen.
No, so here's, I do have some more scathing things.
Yeah.
I just wanted to get that out of the way, kind of breaking the waters. Yeah. So I had a question for you. I feel like, and not just you, I have a feeling, I hear it from other people too, and you can kind of tell where people's mindset is when they bring up the topic, but both of y'all seem to kind of focus on the looting aspect of what happened during the George Floyd protests and riots and stuff. And I just, because to me, I could, and I had this, you know, somewhat of this conversation with you on Facebook, but I just could really give a shit less about property. And y'all aren't the only ones. Like, I'm out in, you know, I'm going to my accounts now, you know, bars and restaurants should have been open. And I can tell from talking with people when they bring it up, if they bring up looting and riots, it's in a negative manner. And then you'll hear people that understand what's going on and understand the outrage refer to it as protests.
Yeah.
It's kind of like a really nuanced linguistic that I've noticed with a lot of people.
Yeah.
So what about what transpired, you know, 2.5 weeks ago?
Yeah.
Or beginning then made you focus on that aspect of what's happening.
I think that when we recorded that, it was probably right.
It was pretty fresh. Yeah, it was real fresh.
Like, that's all news outlets and stuff we're talking about. When you go looking online about what's in the news.
Yeah.
It's like, that's basically what was happening that day and whatever we looked at. Yeah, I mean, I looked at anyways.
I mean, for me, it's like,
because that was in the news, but that wasn't the only thing that was going on. Like there were a lot, like the shit that started during the daytime in most cases were peaceful protests.
Yeah,
maybe aggressive,
right?
But fairly peaceful stuff, and it seemed like in the nighttime there was a different crowd that came in.
Yeah.
That just wanted to fuck shit up.
Yeah.
You know?
Well, and I get that too. I mean, I get wanting to fuck shit up. So,
I mean, for me, it's like, I didn't want to, like, 2 days or whenever we talked about that, I didn't want to obviously talk about, like, the glaring tragedy. You know, it's like,
right. That's pretty apparent.
Yeah. It's like, I didn't feel like I'd even need to address that. I mean,
yeah.
If anybody's seen the video, it's obviously, it's, you know, horrible.
Yeah.
It's very hard to watch and infuriating.
Yeah.
So I just didn't feel like I need to even talk about that.
Right.
The reason I brought up the looting was just because there was, you know, this, that's just kind of the way I process things. I try to look at it from a different angle.
Yeah.
And so, you know, what I was seeing on my news feed was, you know, peaceful protests. Sure, there was, the majority of them were, but all the looting and all the looting. For me, just, I personally don't understand the looting aspect. I even get rioting. I get protesting. I just don't get stealing shit. But that's just me.
Let's talk about that.
I just don't really think it's necessary. I mean,
it doesn't do anything for the cause. I think
it actually hurts.
It does.
Yeah.
Because the majority of the population sees that, they're going to feel like you do. They don't want to see, you know, things that are closer to their home getting burned down. They don't want to see police stations getting burned down, which I got to tell you, when I watched that shit happen live.
Oh, really?
The in Minneapolis.
Crazy.
I was fucking with it, man. Yeah. I was cheering those motherfuckers on, dude. You know, it may be a little extreme, but I was with it. I was
the epicenter.
So angry. And not just of that case. There have been so many cases in Minneapolis of unarmed black people, the Philandro Castile that had a license for the gun. Yeah. They got shot by the police officer while he was reaching for his fucking license.
Yeah.
That he just told the cop that he was going to provide him with was outrageous.
That was in Minneapolis too?
Yeah.
Wow.
Eef. Yeah. I mean, it's, I was definitely cheering those people on.
Yeah.
But so I don't know if you've seen, there was a woman in Minneapolis named Kimberly Jones who was interviewed a day or probably 2-3 days into it. And she was asked about, looting.
Yeah.
And one of the main points that she brought up was that people are so concerned with the action, they don't think about why they're doing it.
Yeah.
And she said, imagine being living in this country and having nothing and seeing everyone else around you with something and thinking that your only opportunity to get that is to go climb through a shattered window.
Yeah.
I mean, that's a kind of hard place to put yourself.
Yeah.
You know, I can't imagine being, I've been busted out. I've been fucking flat broke before, negative money in my fucking bank account before, and been estranged from my parents at the time and not had any kind of, like, I understand hitting the bottom.
Yeah.
But to then look at that and say, hey, I'm going to go take advantage of this opportunity so I can go get those things that I see everybody else have. Like, that's a hard place to put yourself. That's a hard place to imagine yourself mentally being.
That's why I'm saying I don't really get it.
Like, I mean, it's hard to comprehend the mindset.
I can't ever see myself getting to that point to where I personally would do that. That's why I'm saying I don't get it.
I mean, I get it in the aspect of, like, everybody's fucking really angry, and that's just a fucking, that's
part of rioting is looting, unfortunately.
Yeah, I mean, it does come along with it.
The front windows of a storefront, it's like, well nobody's going to go in.
There's the shit just sitting there.
Exactly.
And the police are busy over here.
Yeah, exactly. Alarms are going off everywhere. Like, you bust out this window and the arms triggers this alarm. It's like, yeah, there's fucking 20 alarms going off. Nobody knows it's fucking coming from here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, and that's the thing. I feel like, a lot of the mainstream media from either side wanted to kind of lump all these people into one group.
Oh yeah.
And they're totally different groups. Like you ask people that are there during the day protesting, they can tell you when the sun's going down, they start seeing people that they hadn't seen there all day.
Right.
And they're there and they start fucking shit up and breaking windows.
There was a protest here in Denton, I think like a week later. I saw
some of that live.
Yeah, and it was after the sun went down, there was like these two kids they were trying to spray paint something on the courthouse, and there was some police kind of just around, because that curfew was about to hit. And so a bunch of the protesters alerted the police of these guys, like, they're about to fuck this peaceful protest up.
Yeah.
By vandalizing the fucking courthouse.
Yeah.
And they got...
You saw a lot of that. You saw a lot of that on video where, these people that were there for the right reasons, and unfortunately, not all of it, but unfortunately, it seemed like a lot of the people that were there doing that shit have my skin color.
Oh, yeah.
They were skinny little white kids dressed up like ninjas.
For sure, yeah.
That are, I get it. I get that you're mad at the system, but this isn't your fucking cause right now.
Yeah.
This is for someone other than you.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
This is why we're all here right now.
Mm-hmm.
And it seemed like a real selfish thing.
Yeah, there was another video of these two kids. They're trying to spray paint a BLM on a Starbucks.
Yep. And a lady came up. She's
don't
like,
be
what
doing
the
that
fuck
shit.
Are you
yeah,
doing?
What are you doing? Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
They're going to blame that on me.
Yeah.
Assholes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Some of the weird shit that popped, man. I mean, did y'all see? So you saw, I'm sure you saw the umbrella guy that was smashing the windows on the AutoZone.
Yeah.
And wasn't part of the protest and then tried to walk away and then tried to fight one of the protesters that tried to stop him. And there was a lot of shit online about him being a fucking cop in the St. Paul, not Minneapolis, but St. Paul Police Department. There's a lot of back and forth about that. There's people claiming that his wife has come out and said, yes, that's my gas mask that he had on.
Yeah.
And then there's also been people to completely refute that and say, no, that's not even real. So I have no idea what to think, but it was very strange. He was all by himself. He wasn't part of it. He was carrying a fucking umbrella and all dressed in black with a fucking gas mask on. Yeah. And he's just breaking windows.
Yeah.
He didn't even try and jump in and steal anything. He just popped his fucking umbrella and walked away. It was so weird.
That is weird.
Do you see videos of the cops like breaking their own fucking car windows, smashing their windows and shit?
Yeah.
Yeah, I've seen videos of like cops unloading bricks out of a police truck.
Yes, there were there were so many videos.
That
and
was
so
weird. The bricks were weird.
There were so many different random brick drops in so many different cities.
Yeah, just a random pile of bricks on the street.
Just there was one in like no Frisco. Construction anywhere.
There's one in Frisco, at like the corner of like these two busy streets. My sister lives kind of outside of Frisco.
That's fucking wild.
Or she works outside of Frisco, I think. And she was like.
It seems so weird, man. Like there's so, weird. It seems like there's so many bad actors in this situation.
Yeah.
Between the fucking police, I think, and between, so they're the president for some reason has decided that the catchphrase now is going to be Antifa, that they're going to be the bad guys.
Yeah.
But it's really looking like. The FBI investigation into a lot of this stuff has come back with nothing about Antifa, and it's actually looking like it's like the Boogaloo movement people, which are not always, but kind of thought to be like right-wing extremist. Yeah. But they're really, I don't even know if you want to call them right-wing extremists, because they're not, they don't have some sort of Republican Democrat political affiliation. They're people who see the consistent like tyranny of this government increase over the years and have a problem with it. Like, so did y'all hear about, I forget what city it was in, but it was a state trooper that got killed in an ambush in California recently?
No.
So he, this guy, I wrote down his name. So Stephen Carrillo is another guy in a long line of ex-military or ex-cops who have now decided their only means to fight this government is to wage war against police departments. He set up a trap. There were IEDs involved. One officer, yes, one officer is dead. Another one is in critical condition.
Holy fuck.
And he is just the last line. And guys like that Chris Dorner cat in the Dave Chappelle thing that he talked about. The guy that killed those cops in Dallas is named Micah Johnson. He was also in the fucking military. The guy that killed the four cops in Louisiana, whose name is Gavin Long. He was also in the fucking military.
Yeah.
All these people that have seen the inside of how our government functions.
They're like trying to burn it
down. And seeing how, you know, these cops treat. Yeah. And it is black people do get the front of the impact. But cops kill all kinds of people.
Oh, yeah.
Cops kill fucking white people. They kill Hispanics. They kill children. Yeah, they kill dogs. Like, cops murder so many fucking things every year. It's fucking ridiculous.
Yeah.
But what's making all these guys?
That is kind of weird.
Feel like this is their last option. Like, it's...
Well, and they're kind of going on like suicide missions almost.
Basically, they know what's going to happen. I don't know. It's a real thing. Like I feel like legitimately in the week and a half that there were really, really, really hard protests going, very confrontational, what almost some people would call police riots, because there have been other times that we've seen things, aggressive actions from the police.
Yeah.
Like this, like the 1968 Democratic National Convention.
Yeah.
There were considered police riots because the police went in there and beat up fucking protesters. Like that's what we're seeing now.
Yeah.
But I feel like during that time we saw, and if you want to look them up, I can tell you why. And if you don't want to go into it, then that's fine. But by my count, the first, the third, the fourth, the sixth, and the eighth amendments have been violated by multiple police departments across the country just during these protests. Not to consider like all the other times that they do this, that they overreach.
Yeah.
So I get it. I mean, that's something that I thought about, and this is hard to say because it's pretty fucking radical, but are those guys bad guys? Not everyone, but there's so many like comic strips and shit, so many movies and pieces of entertainment where we look at people who are willing to sacrifice everything to fight like the ultimate, what they considered the ultimate evil.
Yeah.
What all these guys do. I mean, that's a hard proposal to make. Like this guy just murdered a lot of them, murdered randomly, you know, with disregard. You know, but
it's kind of like it's tough, like half terroristic and it's half sort of, like true
vigilantism
American.
Almost
yeah
in a weird way.
I don't know, I mean I think that doing it random is kind of not the move.
Yeah. Yeah, but, I mean, because then that kind of detracts from the statement that you're trying to make, right?
If yeah, you're just, I mean, I like the sentiment, though.
Right. If you're gonna say that, you know, I'm going after this police department because of the actions that they've allowed to occur with their officers and mm-hmm. cover-ups that have happened, and like with the Chris Dorner thing where he got fired.
Yeah.
For fucking pointing out a guy like Chappelle said who had done everything right, who got fired for pointing out the overreach of a fellow officer.
Mm-hmm.
Where does this guy think that he has to go? Like, what are his other alternatives? He followed every legal course.
Yeah.
Yeah, he did the right thing.
He did the right thing until he
tried
did,
to.
Until he did that shit.
Right.
You know?
Right. Yeah.
I don't it's a tough question. I mean, I don't know. It's hard, but I see their point of view.
Yeah.
I get it 100%.
Sure.
Yeah. Yeah, I do too.
But I'm
not like making IEDs and going out there.
Right. That. Yeah. Same. Well, I don't know, man. I mean, I'm strapped up, y'all.
Those look like new shoes.
Well, they are new shoes. I've gotten into shoes here lately.
Oh, nice. Sneakers.
Let's talk about guns first.
No. Yeah.
I was talking to Drew earlier, and I really feel like part of what's happened is kind of, I don't know. I've never been a big fan of government, never been a big fan of police. You know, I told you earlier, I feel like my interactions with, I've been arrested probably 7 or 8 times. My interaction with police is about 50-50 or so.
Yeah.
You know, it's not, it hasn't all been bad. It hasn't all been good.
Right.
But I don't know where I was going with that. I got completely lost. I'm sorry.
I was about to hit you with the Jeopardy music.
And, you fucking should have. You definitely fucking should have.
That was a good pause. It was very dramatic.
With no payoff. Oh, that's so embarrassing. I just completely lost my train of thought.
That's all right. No,
welcome to my fucking brain.
We'll listen to it, then I'll come punch
it. Yeah, punch it in. Punch it in. Let's fucking punch it in.
Yeah.
Digital recording platforms. Let's fucking go.
Shit.
No, I mean, we kind of touched. I talked to Drew earlier. I haven't talked to you about this. Run the Jewels.
I love them, but I haven't heard the new album yet.
Dude, the new album is fucking amazing, man. Yeah, it's really good.
I listened to a couple songs off it, but yeah, it was
really Killer funny. Mike's speech was pretty powerful.
Killer Mike is Mike Renner is a fucking genius.
Yeah, yeah.
Like he really is. If you haven't watched it, and not just the short little, there's a soundbite with Killer Mike. From last year's Revolt Summit, which is kind of like a panel of different black people with different political views, and there was a moderator, and they wanted to talk about what they thought that black people needed to do in order to help their situation out from Marin.
Yeah,
and it's about, I want to say it's like 2 hours, maybe 1 hour 45, the whole thing, but it's worth a watch. It's worth a fucking watch. But yeah, I mean, you know, his big thing, as it kind of always is, it was funny. There was a time where there was a section where so T.I. is there.
Mm-hmm.
Also Candace Owens is there.
Yeah.
And so they were kind of going back and forth about Donald Trump and not Donald Trump and Democrats and Republicans and all the shit. And after they got done, the moderator turns and like, well, Mike, you've been pretty quiet the whole time. I'm going to go ahead and give you the floor. And he goes through this whole thing, and I can't say anything that he says because I'm white.
Right.
So he goes through all that, and he's like, what I hear right now is a bunch of free people arguing over who's got the best master.
Yeah.
He's like, I don't care. If it's Donald Trump, you know, Joe Biden,
mm-hmm.
yo mama, my mama, I don't care who it is. If they're willing to do whatever's good for black people and whatever's good for this country, yeah. then they got my fucking ear.
Yeah.
Obviously, he's not a Trump fan.
Right.
Obviously, he's not even a Joe Biden fan. I mean, his dude was Bernie from the fucking get-go, so...
Yeah.
He's a big-time Bernie fan.
Yeah.
But yeah, the whole kill your master... And start over kind of thing. Like, stop arguing over all this fucking partisan politics bullshit, totally. All this, personality, identity politics and shit. Yes. Which both sides claim the other one is doing it, and they're both fucking, that's all they are. Like, all Trump is the biggest identity politician ever.
Yeah.
Ever. Of all time.
Well, and almost by claiming that the other side is doing it, you're doing it.
Yeah.
Ironically.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's like a fucking snake eating its tail.
Yeah.
It's like a turd eating a turd, right?
Exactly.
You just end up with a big turd.
Yeah.
A big fucking
shits itself out.
It's all mushed together. It fucking does nothing.
Pussies and dicks all covered in shit. <That's>,
yeah.
I did like that part in the latest Chappelle thing, in the 846 thing, where he was, at the end, he was... You could tell it was, it's pretty somber. There was a couple jokes in there, and he's like, oh, don't worry, I got some pussy jokes if y'all need them.
Yeah.
See, I don't think that we saw that video. I just saw like a smaller clip.
I think we saw
only...
like the first half.
Yeah.
Oh, dude, it's like half an hour.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, we watched like an 8-minute video.
Yeah. It's like half an hour. It's fucking, brilliant.
The one we saw was pretty much just
Did it not have the Chris Dorner part?
It did.
Okay, yeah. So it talked about that.
It was like only that.
I think it kicked off.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it kicked off pretty much when he was like...
it was the George
talking
Floyd
about,
part.
Yeah, yeah.
Dude, that...
When he started saying 8 minutes, 46 seconds when he first started saying it, like kind of over and over again, that's kind of when the video we saw picked up.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
So I don't know how far into it was.
That shit... I mean, that shit's just wild. He was born at 8:46 in the morning. Dave Chappelle was. That's he says that in the full thing.
Wow.
That's why he says he can't get that number out of his head. Because he was born at 8:46 in the morning, and this man kneeled on this guy's neck
for
8 minutes, 46 seconds. Did it show the part where he was talking about why George Floyd calling out for his mother resonated with him?
Yeah.
Because the only other time he had seen that
was when his dad
was dying. I mean, that's
heavy shit.
That is some real heavy shit, man. Like how he knew that man knew he was going to fucking die.
Yeah.
I mean, this shit is just, that is fucking horrid, man.
It is.
And it's unfortunately, unfucking fortunately, like that's not, shit's not a fucking isolated incident.
Yeah.
It's really not. It's
Well, I mean, if anything now, I mean, obviously there should have been probably a spotlight on it long before, but if anything now, I mean, everybody has a spotlight on them now.
Oh yeah.
So,
I mean,
if it does accomplish anything, I mean, that is definitely something that just naturally is going to happen from it, I think. Things like body cams and I think police officers should get mental health training, like how to deal with people with mental health issues.
Yeah. Or have a different department that's not armed police officers deal with that kind of shit.
Yeah, like domestic stuff, like just, you know, or just people who are, you know, down on their luck, you know, homeless, vagrants and stuff, you know, a lot of times police have to deal with them. And, I mean, somebody's brutally schizophrenic. I mean, and just it's some dude fresh out of high school, you know,
with a fucking gun is not going to go well. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, I'm with you. I know that, you know, the defund the police thing is like the new tag word, and it's getting bad press, but I don't think it's a bad thing. I mean, there have been people saying that we need to divest from law enforcement and put back into social works for fucking decades now, because we've been taken away from social works. We've been taken away from education.
Yeah.
It's like, it's wild to me. I was thinking about that the other day. I decided to look up and see how much, roughly how much of every tax dollar that you pay, what it goes towards.
Mm-hmm.
25% of your tax dollars go to the military. A quarter of every tax dollar you pay goes to the military.
Oh, yeah.
Two fucking pennies go to education.
Yeah.
That's why this nation is full of a bunch of dumb fucking idiots.
Yeah. I was reading about that actually. And
that shit is fucking crazy.
Space.
We spend the same amount of money on the military as we do on social programs. About 24-25% of your tax, every tax dollar goes towards social programs.
Yeah.
Medicaid, Medicare, Social Security, all that bullshit, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
And then the rest is just like split up slightly between infrastructure programs, and then it's like 14 cents. You pay 2 cents out of every tax dollar for education, but you pay 14 cents for politicians' salaries.
Mm. Yeah.
That's fucking crazy to me.
Yeah. That's ridiculous.
Yeah. It's fucking insane.
Yeah. There's definitely a problem when, you know, a politician could go into Congress making like 6 figures a year and then get out making 8.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's a pretty huge issue.
It's wild.
Yeah.
No, it's...
I wish you could do that as a
I
musician.
Really hope... So do y'all remember... Mm-hmm. Yeah, right?
That'd be amazing.
Do y'all remember those senators that got... with the, that kind of got caught with the insider trading.
Yeah.
Yeah.
With like,
dude,
they had inside information
to them. Yeah. That's fucking crazy.
So I thought that they were being investigated was the last thing that I heard. There's been no investigation at all.
Nothing.
Really? Are you sure?
They made like it was a girl and a guy, and the girl made like a half-ass apology, but was really like, I didn't do anything wrong. I was my financial planners and I have this, and it's a very standard move.
Yeah.
And then
yeah,
that was kind
I heard
of
him.
It.
I heard him say that, and like heard some people say like, "Oh, just some people are better at playing the fucking stock market than others." Like,
no,
yeah, they're great at playing the stock market when they know what the fuck's coming and what's about to happen.
Right. Yeah, fucking,
this shit is crazy. Those motherfuckers, both of those people. I don't care. Like, I'm all for justice most of the time. The second that news came out, they should have been strung up in the fucking square. And burned alive so that no, even if they were fucking innocent, fuck that shit. Let's prove a point. Yeah. Let's sacrifice whatever we got to sacrifice to make sure that these motherfuckers don't think they're untouchable.
Yeah.
Because they all think they're fucking untouchable.
That's the big problem is like they think that nothing can hurt them. And then if they get caught, they're just like, so what?
Yeah.
What are you going to do about it?
Yeah.
What are you going to do about it?
Yeah.
Absolutely fucking nothing.
I'm a senator.
A retired veteran is gonna come kill you.
Yeah.
And
okay, so
you're not gonna see it. You're not gonna hear it.
Mm-hmm.
We talked about that.
You're gonna start your car and
boom.
I got a car bomb on here, dude.
You're gonna start your car and. Sorry.
Yeah.
That's the wrong car.
What happened?
That was a car bomb.
That was a
car exploding.
Bomb.
Oh, I thought it was going to be a drink.
Oh,
those are good.
Yeah. I haven't done a car bomb in a long time.
Irish.
You know, y'all, I haven't drank really more than anything but like sampling a beer here or there in like over a year.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah, I haven't really drank that much in the last year or so either.
It really.
How's it feel?
I don't feel any different. I really don't.
Are y'all trying to tell me something?
No.
Listen,
drink,
Billy.
Drink up.
We know you like to have a good time, all right?
Yeah.
That's
true.
Really, really, you know.
I actually don't drink that often either. Maybe once or twice a week.
No.
Is that often?
No. Every day is often.
I'd say that's often.
No.
I'd consider that often. I don't know. I mean, during the quarantine, I didn't really drink at all. Well, I did a little bit, but not
that's
much.
Weird. I feel like a lot of people turn into alcoholics during quarantine.
That, well, see, I didn't want to just be sitting around.
Didn't you tell
drunk
me you drank Seven Trulies one day?
Yeah, but that was like over the course of like 2 days, and then I didn't drink for a while.
Oh, okay.
I was gonna when the quarantine first started, I went to and got like a 12-pack of those Trulies, and I was like, I'm just gonna keep these in the fridge and then just have them. So I
were
don't
you,
have to,
were you on your period or something?
No. They're
fucking great. Have you had them?
I sell them. I know what they are.
Have you had them?
Yes. Do it. No, I'm good. I don't like, honestly, like I don't know. So when I was in high school, I started working at fast food, right?
Uh-huh.
And at first it was like, I love these burgers every day. And then 6 months into it, it's like, can't even stand the smell of burgers. I don't like really, if I'm going to drink, I will drink liquor.
Yeah,
like I'll probably drink whiskey or scotch, and that's really about it. Because clear liquors are for rich white women on diets.
Yeah, I don't like a clear liquor.
No.
Yeah. I do like a good gin and tonic, though.
Yeah.
Does that make me a white woman?
Shit. It does, Karen. It does make you a white woman.
Hey, yeah. I would like to talk to the manager, please.
What? Yeah. What the fuck is... So I know middle-aged white woman.
Uh-huh.
I have one for a mother.
Yeah.
When did they start not minding their own goddamn business?
I don't know.
This seems... I don't know if people just got more means
the Karens,
to record.
You mean?
Yeah, the Karens.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know if people just have more means to record. Because some of them are like... Okay, so the racist ones, like... I know that those have always... But just people that are just mad at people for...
Yeah.
Just doing normal human interactions and shit.
You know what? I think it is. I think it's always been happening.
We just didn't have this shit with us all the time.
Cameras.
Exactly. Yeah. And it's so quick to just boot your camera up now. It's just like a thumb swipe and boom.
And it's right and there. Yeah. Yeah. You don't even necessarily have to unlock it. Yeah. Like your camera is right there on your home your unlock screen.
Yeah. Somebody comes up to you and hits you with a sentence and you're like, whoa, hold on.
Let me get my phone.
Yeah.
I'm recording you right
what
now.
What do you want
dude.
Me to say? Let's see. What can I say?
Talk about how you're a racist.
Okay.
Let's see. I'm sorry. Oh no.
Were you just taking a bunch of
photos? I have 87 pictures of you now.
You're fucking welcome.
What a gem I am.
Yeah, dude.
Oh, such a gem.
You should have talked about NASCAR, man. Talk about how you're a racist.
Oh yeah. Yeah, this. We can't forget what this is about. This is about you being a racist.
I collect erasers. I'm an e-racist.
Oh, so you're wiping out racists?
Yeah.
Oh no,
you're erasing.
You're racist via
you're
email.
You're erasing.
Ooh,
you're racist via email.
Be careful with
you're
that.
E-racist.
I was about to say I'm erasing all races, but that doesn't sound.
Yeah, when you say all racist, it sounds like all races.
That is what I almost said.
Oh.
So, yeah, that's not what I meant.
Well, your true thoughts are coming out.
Little Freudian slip, huh?
Yeah.
God damn it.
Why don't you tell us more about your book there?
Let's hear about how your grandfather raised you.
Yeah. Let's talk about how you think the Confederate flag is about cultural heritage and not slavery.
I mean, they should just leave the statues alone. I'm just kidding. God damn it.
You can't joke about that now. See, that's something that, okay, so someone I was talking to Drew about earlier before you got home. It's a hard place to be because I'm definitely all for freedom of expression, free art, free thought.
Yeah.
All of that.
Mm-hmm.
I don't like all this. Let's ban all these fucking old movies and ban these books and all that shit. Like you're a fucking Nazi if you do that. The statues, though, I don't really have a problem with removing them because they're all like commissioned by government or they're commissioned by these fucking racist groups.
Well, and they're not even really like.
This is not like artwork, man. Yeah, you're just doing a portrait of somebody.
Like, yeah, it was sort of historic. He's just old. Like, that's the history of it. Like,
yeah.
He was alive 120 years ago. Like,
yeah.
Like, who gives a shit?
Yeah, he was an officer on the losing side of a...
Yeah. I mean, I always think just, like, anytime I see a statue, any statue, I'm like, who is this person? And... If it's interesting, then I'm like, oh, wow, what a cool statue. Mm. If it
it's like is, he yeah. ran 4,000 slaves yeah, through exactly. the...
Yeah, it didn't got started. They where they kept all the blacks out of the square, and you're just like, Jesus Christ.
No thanks. Yeah. Why do we need a reminder of this?
Check,
yeah.
please.
Yeah, exactly. It's like,
but see, even so, like, what? Well, let's put it like, okay, so let's say like there's a statue of Dirk outside the American Airlines.
Did
center,
they put
right?
one up?
There, if there's not, there should be. I thought there was.
Be. I think there might be.
I yeah. thought there was, but yeah. let's just say, oh, say, okay,
they named Nowitzki Avenue.
I think there's a statue.
Yeah, there might be a statue.
So let's say there is a statue. Okay. We'll go with that premise.
Yeah, yeah.
What if he fights dogs?
And we
out?
Right, or we find out like 20 years that like he was legit running a child slave network.
Dirk, say it ain't so.
Then we tear the fucking statue down,
yeah,
right?
Do. Yeah.
Fuck that shit.
But what if Dirk made Thriller?
You still you don't get rid of Thriller. That's our work. Even if he did a little
Thriller's
boys
the wild
you
card.
Just let it.
What if he ran a child sex trade, which it pretty much
it sounds
like
he did. Like, yeah, I don't know. Well, I don't know. I don't know if you
I
can.
Can't help it as a great song though. I gotta stand by that.
Me too.
I'm sorry.
No. I can separate
and
the
I'm sorry
from
to all the families.
I just see, I see a little white kid's butthole every time.
You know, I think you have to have seen that first before you can picture it, right? So yeah. Where would you, where
you when I was a kid,
where do you see you
so I was a little white kid at one point.
Yeah.
Really? You never looked at your butthole in a mirror?
Like your butthole.
Really? You don't know what your own butthole looks like?
Looks
okay.
Like, yeah.
Well, at least maybe not, you know, in the past, you know, couple months, but like you've seen your butthole before, right?
Yeah, last week.
Anytime you feel something weird.
I got to take a peek at that, right?
Yeah. You're getting like a little tickle or something. I'll go check it out immediately.
Who?
Not really.
Hello there.
Even when you say go check it out, you mean stick something in it. That's what you mean by check it out, right?
Woo!
Ooh.
He means chuck it in because...
Yeah. Yeah,
open for business.
I can't get that line out of my head. The strip naked and run backward into a field of dicks.
Ron Jules.
So good.
Yeah, dude.
It's so good.
Eloquent and precise.
Absolutely. What else could describe that situation? Yeah. I like it a lot.
I need to listen to that album.
RTJ's fucking great. I am absolutely late to the party. I had, it was probably... Man, it might have been 2 weeks ago, like right after this stuff started happening. My buddy Phil told me, he was like, "You ever listen to Run the Jewels?" And I was like, "I have no idea. No, never, never heard of them." He's like, "Dude, I know you're not the biggest hip hop fan or rap or whatever the fuck you want to call it." He's like, "But you need to go check that shit out."
Yeah.
And so I did, and I checked out the first three albums, and then like. Right as I'm listening to this, the new album came out.
Nice, yeah.
And I have been listening to Run the Jewels almost every day.
Yeah.
And I'm ready to overthrow the government.
Yeah.
I'm ready to burn it all down. I definitely am.
I love their beats.
You're indoctrinated.
Dude, all the fuck... Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. The music, that's the thing, too. Like, the music is fucking... And if you haven't heard if you haven't heard Four yet...
Yeah.
There's some crazy, just different styles of music. There's different styles of music on every fucking album. It's great.
Yeah.
I love how they make fun of fucking mumble rap all the time.
Yeah.
Because that shit is fucking terrible.
Yeah, it's...
All those SoundCloud rappers can go fuck themselves.
Yeah, I agree. Yeah. We get them every time we post something with music related. They're always like...
Hit me in my
hit
DMs.
Hit me up in my DMs. It's like, no, you're hitting me up because you like what we did. You hit us up. I'm not going to seek you out. Like, what the fuck am I going to get out of that?
Unbelievable.
Unbelievable.
Pay him a little bit of money.
Fucking, what was that? Little Peep. R.I.P. Little Peep.
Yeah.
Dude, have you listened to Little Dicky?
Yeah, Little Dicky is funny.
Little Dicky's pretty funny.
That show, Dave, is really funny.
Yeah. I had heard that. I want to watch that at some point.
The season finale, he's showing his music video to the record company he gets signed for, and it's about him going to jail and then like having to suck this dude's dick and stuff like that.
I don't know if I'm... I mean, I think I might be good.
It's
I think
hilarious.
I might be good.
It's hilarious.
Yeah. So... I've been really trying, baby, baby.
Yeah, it's like that, but with like a trap beat under it.
No thanks. No thanks.
Just so we're in time.
Okay. That's going to be a weird fucking
That was
cut.
A weird cut, yeah. It's
Do we have technical difficulties?
We had a little technical difficulties, yeah. The camera stops. So if you're watching this later on YouTube, there'll be, I don't know how many minutes, maybe up to an hour of no video. But we're catching the end
no
here.
No big deal. Yeah. No big deal. Just a black screen for you to stare at.
Yeah, yeah.
We'll put some nice imagery there.
Yeah.
I mean, a nice meadow lake.
Mm-hmm.
Or our logo.
Yeah, I don't know what's going on with the camera thing. I can't.
We're figuring it out, guys.
Yeah, I'm new to the video, so.
I'm new, I don't know what to do.
Yeah, I'm new. Oh, I say that all the time, and nobody yeah. ever gets it.
Yeah. I'm new, I don't know what to do.
Is it still, how much is in there?
Got the poo on me.
Fucking call back to Joe Dirt.
Mr. DJ himself.
Yeah, so we were talking shit about mumble rappers, but I think we had
I don't know what else you need to say about that. I mean, it's pretty self-explanatory.
You guys get it.
Quick little edit there.
I told you guys I've been trying to learn to play the drums for the past couple of months.
Uh-huh.
I see that.
It has been a lot of fun.
A musical journey.
It is fun.
Very humbling. I was talking to Drew earlier about I don't feel like since I was maybe 13 and first learning how to play the guitar that I've felt like I had to crawl for so long on an instrument. It's super nuanced. I don't think there's a more expressive instrument in modern music without the addition of like effects. Like you can do so much with just what you're playing and the dynamics. Yeah. That I don't think you can really accomplish with any other instruments. It's a lot of fun. It is fucking hard. This shit is fucking hard though, man.
It is hard.
It's frustrating at times.
Yeah. My right hand and my right foot are pretty good. My left hand's okay. My left foot, no.
I've got to where I can do like pretty consistent eighths or quarters with my left foot while I'm playing.
Like open-handed.
Fairly simple beats on with both like hi-hat and snare. Ride and snare and kick.
Yeah.
With that hi-hat holding an eighth or a quarter note. But as far as like using it and like interdependent patterns and stuff, not a thing. I can't do that shit.
Me neither.
Yeah. I mean, we could get really deep into it if you wanted to, but.
Yeah, talk to me. What the fuck else we got to do? You got a hot date tonight or something?
No, man. Your mom's out of town.
Oh.
I didn't. I'm glad you took some time out of your busy schedule stupping my mom to
stood her up. I got shit to do.
Sorry, I told her out of thing. But yeah, dude, I mean, independence like that, it's, you have to think about it as one rhythm.
See, and that's
like if you're playing piano,
where all the syncopation lines up with what your other limbs are doing and shit. Yeah. And that's hard, man. Mm-hmm. That shit is fucking super difficult.
Yeah, it's something that not a lot of people really talk to you about when you're learning drums. And
well, nobody's talked to me about anything while I'm learning drums, mm-hmm. except for you earlier today. Yeah. Where you've been for the past 4 months? Yeah. No, I've gotten a lot of really good advice from Blake too. I've reached out to him about that.
Yeah,
and he was kind enough to kind of guide me along at the beginning of my journey.
Yeah,
he's definitely kind.
I kind of went through a similar thing with piano, just learning the piano because I had been trying to teach myself for a couple of years. And then when I joined Circadian and I started trying to write music on the piano, like with a band.
Yeah.
What do you do?
Yeah, it was like a totally fucking new thing. And I was like, where do I even fucking start? So I was just, like the first like five practices with them, I pretty much just had headphones on and just playing to myself because I was literally
just trying to figure out the keys
where they were and like figuring out what notes
you
got to
learn the instrument before you just dive head first.
Yeah. Well, what's funny now is when I go back and
like hear some of the stuff I wrote when I was first starting.
Yeah.
It's like I was playing easy stuff because like
that's all you could do.
So it's all right handed.
Yeah.
Like left hand was never ever involved.
Like not doing anything at all.
Not doing anything.
Not playing along.
Not even
with,
trying to play the root.
Nothing at all.
No. Controlling the mod wheel and the pitch wheel.
That was enough.
That's it. Yeah.
Okay.
And maybe the cutoff knob, you know. Yeah.
Right. That sounds like a
how's that go?
Sounds like a Oberheim two pole filter. And that was more of a four pole mode kind of thing.
Dang, you know your synthesis.
You need to. I mean,
he knows his poles.
I have a lot of very nice synthesizers I love very much.
I tell people that story sometimes. Whenever like last time we went down to Austin, me and Blake. And Blake went to that CrossFit thing in the morning.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And you're like, well, what do you want to do? And I was like, I don't know. I mean, you want to go to that synth place? And you're like, yeah, we could do that. And then like 5 minutes later, you're like, you know what? I got all that shit upstairs.
Yeah. Yeah.
Let's just go fuck with that. And I was like, yeah, you know what?
Let's just do that. We don't have to go anywhere.
Exactly.
We already got all this shit.
Shoes off.
I have a pretty, you need to come see some of the keyboards that
I've heard, dude. Tales of the awesomeness that lies in your studio.
Yeah.
I've seen some things, some pictures.
The Jupiter.
The Jupiter's by far. I know it's old and maybe not as capable with MIDI and stuff like that as some modern synths. I don't think it's really hard because I have all these other keyboards. And I love their sounds that they give, whether it's that Moog Matriarch was fucking amazing.
I'm glad you finally got that.
Yeah, I'm glad I finally got into that. Took for fucking ever, man. But it was worth it. It's number 27 off the line.
Wow.
It's the 27th
That's
one
cool.
made. Yeah, yeah.
So, you know, management was still there and they were making them doing good.
Well, you know what happened with that, right?
No.
They
shipped them all out and they were going to start shipping them out to everybody. And then Moog was like, send them all back. We need to do some more quality control on them. So before they released them, they shipped them all. Everybody had to ship them all back to Moog for it was a long time, like 3 or 4 months.
Yeah, I never got mine originally.
Yeah.
It just never shipped.
Yeah.
I
called that store for you.
You did. Yeah. Because it got to the point where I just never heard back from the guy. And I didn't, with that kind of shit, like I am understanding to the end. If it's supply side stuff, that shit happens to me all the time.
Right.
I get it. But fucking talk to me. Let me know. Yeah. Send me a fucking email.
Exactly.
Tell me, hey, or don't even give me a tentative ETA if you're not certain that this is a time frame that we're looking at. Just say, hey, this has been paused indefinitely because of X issue or whatever, and we'll go from there. Instead, a lot of these companies, and it's not just Guitar Center, Vintage King is the same way.
Yeah.
Sweetwater is different. Sweetwater will communicate with you. Carson McClain will fucking email you directly and let you know what the fuck's going on with your thing if it's back ordered or whatever.
Yeah.
But I ordered these. So I really took advantage of, I don't know, it sounds kind of shitty, but I took advantage of all the shit that these companies were doing during the, I don't know what people think is going to be called the great pause, like during March and April and May.
Yeah.
But there, all these companies were having these crazy, like extended financing and all this shit, all this shit on brands you could never get. Like I was telling Drew, so I've been trying to get a different hi-hat. I didn't have a whole lot of different hi-hat options and I had the Istanbul 30th anniversary 22 inch ride, which is fucking amazing. And so I wanted the fucking 30th anniversary 15 inch hi-hats to go with it. And they pair together phenomenally. I mean, they sound so, even though they were made like 2 or 3 years apart, they sound phenomenal together.
They sound really bad. That's what I was playing earlier.
Yeah. That's what's on his set right now. And, so Guitar Center was doing this thing where it was, qualifying orders over $499.
Mm-hmm.
Got 48-month financing.
Yeah.
Regardless of whether or not the brand itself will allow you to do that. So yeah. One of the brands that qualified for that was UFIP, the symbol company, and I wanted one of their symbols for a long time. Got their 19-inch crash, which was on like a 36-month payment plan or something like that.
Yeah.
And on the same ticket, I put the fucking 15-inch Istanbul hi-hats, which are crazy fucking expensive. It's like $678. It's like over $700 for the pair.
Yeah.
Which is fucking insane. Like, I don't have that money to put out, but I can pay for it in equal installments over 48 months.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And so it got added to the ticket, and show enough, I got till 2023 pay these motherfuckers off. Yeah. And I couldn't be more happy. Yeah. It's fucking great.
Yeah, I did something similar, because when we switched computers, like, I was using, you know, Blake's Mac forever.
Yeah.
And I had a ton of Waves plugins on it. A lot of them.
WAVs?
WAVs plugins.
WAVs plugins, yeah.
Say it right. Pay the price.
I had a lot of WAVs plugins on there. So, like, then we started doing the podcast on this computer, I was, like, really starting to miss some of them. Because, I mean, even though there was a lot of them on that on Blake's computer, I really only used, like, five of them for the podcasting. And even for, like, instrument recording and stuff, like a limiter, a gate, just really nice ones that I know how to work right, you know, and dial in really well,
and that work well in response, right. That they're give you the reaction that you want.
So, like, I didn't have any of those. I thought I would be able to copy them onto my hard drive and then dump them on this computer, but for some reason it just didn't happen. So I was like, well, shit, I lost all those.
A lot of licensing won't let you transfer it. Yeah. It may let you transfer it to a second hard drive, but after that, you're kind of fucked. So if they had ever been on any other hard drive before then, then that might have been what's going on. Yeah. I don't know. I don't have a lot of Waves stuff because they're so goddamn expensive.
Yeah.
I fuck around with the Slate Digital stuff, which is really cool. It's like $170-something a month for a year for all of their plugins, and their plugins are legit. There's a lot of them that are really good. They're really phenomenal. A lot of their modeling ones are really cool. But another thing that I know that you're aware of, this brand that took advantage of this, you know, COVID financing and shit, was through Vintage King. And I'd been looking at these. So I have a Lewitt 640 large diaphragm condenser, which is their solid state large diaphragm.
We got a match pair down.
So I just have one.
Yeah.
And they have the 840 and the 940.
Yeah.
Reference grade tube large diaphragm condensers.
Nice.
And so I bought a stereo pair of the 840 ones because they're like 48-month, four fucking year financing, man. Like, I don't know how you can pass that shit up. And they were never on that kind of financing before this shit. And I was lucky. I've been talking to Drew about this too earlier, but I've been really, both Ashley and I were really lucky through the whole situation to never, like, I've lost my incentive pay. Like, every month we had different sales incentives that we could hit to get extra money. Mm-hmm. And I've lost that, but I've at least maintained my base salary, and Ashley's pay hasn't changed at all. So I feel like we were real lucky. And I also felt like it was kind of more or less kind of your, if you made it through that situation without taking any real significant hit to your bank account, is kind of on you to contribute to your local economy and to the global economy too.
Yeah.
Because not everybody had extra money to spend. When we got that stimulus money, I made a real, you know, certain point to Ashley that it's kind of, we don't need this to pay our bills. So we need to find something to spend this on.
Yeah.
So it goes back into the economy.
Yeah. 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 Yeah, I mean, that was kind of, I did a lot of that too. I bought a bunch of stuff that I've been needing to buy for like a year.
Yeah.
But I was just like, well, I don't have $60 to spend on that right now, or I don't have $100 to spend on that right now. And I hit that stimulus. And I was just sitting here doing, playing fucking Spider-Man. And I was like, you know what? I'm going to buy that fucking splitting axe that I've been needing to split all those fucking logs back there, even though it's summer. You pointed that out to me earlier.
Yep. But you're not going to use those logs.
I like
logs
to get prepared. I'm like the studious squirrel.
You're a winter prepper.
Studious, is that the right word?
I think the word you're looking for is racist.
Damn. You fucking got me. I accidentally hit sports.
Dude. Way to go. God damn it. Hell to the no. I love that guy.
I love him too. He passed away.
Oh.
Yeah.
Sad. Great. Just another way to go. Remember, I saw somebody post this the other day, but y'all remember when we thought like 2016 was a bad year because all those fucking artists were dying?
Yeah, that all was those a weird people year, that, though. That
it, was a, it was a weird
for
year.
Deaths. That but, was crazy.
But.
Yeah,
this is a very
but,
sad year for deaths. It doesn't compare.
I mean, no.
It doesn't compare.
No. It's. I don't
now
think
we
it's,
have famous people posting, trying to
John
post or, social media videos and.
Dude. I love that oh god, those Imagine videos are so cringy.
Yeah.
In our fucking multi-million
exactly.
dollar mansions. Imagine no possessions as I sit around this fucking castle here.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ, how out of touch can you fucking be? Yeah. I love that Dave Chappelle made a point of saying I don't know if y'all can tell, but I think Dave Chappelle is
the goat,
is one of the greatest voices of my generation. He's older than me, but we're pretty close. We're close to the same age.
Well,
and
I mean, he's like our generation's Richard Pryor.
Yeah, I mean, and he. I dare you to say
I think
something
he's
that he's. I do too, and I dare you to say that his social commentary is ever off point. I think he's always on point.
He's a smart motherfucker, man. He's like, as much as people think that he's kind of like checked out and sort of like off the grid, like he knows exactly what the fuck's going on.
No, yeah, he's with it.
Yeah.
He's with it. But yeah, he made a point to say, like, does anybody really give a fuck what any celebrity has to say about what the fuck's going on right now?
Yeah,
does anybody care what Ja Rule has to say, right? Nobody gives a fuck what Ja Rule has to say about this shit.
It. He always goes hard on Ja Rule. It's so funny.
I mean, Ja Rule did that to himself.
Yeah. Oh, did you, have you seen the video of him trying to do like, it's like a halftime show at some basketball game. It was like a week after that Fry Festival documentary came out.
Oh.
And he's trying to get the crowd all hyped. It's either pregame or halftime show or something, and it's a basketball game, and the music's starting, and he's just going crazy, and it's just crickets.
Fuck yeah. Fuck yeah.
It is like...
You fucking con artist, motherfucker.
Dude,
get the fuck out of here.
It's so crazy. It's like the whole... That is one thing that's badass about like all these documentaries that have been coming out, and just... Just the amount of content that we have to consume now. I've learned so much shit about people that I don't give a fuck about.
Yeah.
And I'm glad I did. Like, have you seen Tiger? Did you watch Tiger King?
Okay. All right. Yes, absolutely. And I just a couple days ago finally watched the eighth, I guess, the recap episode with fucking Joel McHale.
Yeah.
That
was Zoom shit. That I can't watch that stuff.
But I see the humor in a lot of the memes. I understand how ridiculous that whole thing was.
Yeah.
But through the whole blow up of Tiger King, the thing that got me was like, I didn't understand the love.
I don't understand either.
Because every single, except for the guy with metal legs.
Yeah, he is cool.
And the girl who's now a man or who identifies as a man.
Yeah, lost her arm.
I don't know if she did that during the filming of the documentary or afterwards, but they lost her arm. I think she has a good heart. I think that dude with metal legs has a good heart. Everyone else on that fucking show from that
the blonde
murderous,
guy's okay.
Huh?
The tall blonde guy's okay.
Yeah.
He's got kind of the, you know.
Yeah.
I don't know. He seems like a not very reliable dude, but...
He seems like kind of a dick to me.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I could see
but
that.
Jeff Lowe. Lowe. Yeah. He seems like the total douchebag.
Oh, God.
I mean, Joe Exotic murdered healthy cats.
Mm-hmm.
And when he told the story about how a lady brought a horse to him to help take care of, and the second she got off the property, he shot the fucking horse dead.
Yeah.
And fucking fed it to the tigers. Like, this man was a fucking monster.
Yeah.
Like, everyone that went along with his shit is just as big of a fucking monster as he is.
Yeah.
I never understood all the love for that shit, because watching it after about... Because I hate zoos anyways. I think it's fucked up. Like,
it
you
is.
Can try and... You can try and sell me on the fucking conservationist shit all you want. I don't fucking buy it.
Yeah.
The only reason you have them is because they were bred to be in fucking zoos. Well, let's fucking stop that shit right now.
Yeah.
Let's figure out a way to help out the wild population instead of inbreeding all these fucking animals.
Yeah.
It's just the whole thing is fucking disgusting to me. And the way he ran his zoo was fucking horribly disgusting. And he even said when he took that fucking gorilla to that sanctuary that had been in a fucking 10x10 cage its whole fucking life and saw how happy it was to get to run around.
Yeah.
That it broke his heart. It's like, really? It took that? You saw that shit every day? You shot in the face cats that trusted you.
Yeah.
I mean, that's fucking horrible shit.
Yeah.
Fuck that motherfucker. Fuck all of those. Fuck that ponytail motherfucker with the fucking soul patch.
Oh, God.
That fucking cult leader.
Yeah.
Fuck Carol
totally
Baskins.
Fuck
Carol Baskins too. That fucking bitch.
Yeah.
I'm with Joe Exotic there. Fuck that fucking cunt. She definitely fucking...
I think she murdered him.
She definitely fed
it. The whole sardine juice comment was like, that's all I needed to hear.
Yep, I got you.
That's way too specific.
Yeah.
To use as an example.
I would have never thought of that.
Me neither.
To help feed someone to a tiger.
Yeah.
The only way you think of that is if you've done that
if
before.
If you tried it.
Yeah.
Yeah. If you know for a fact that sardine...
I don't think that's something that you try. I think that's something that you do, and it's effective, and it works.
Yeah,
I don't think you tried it. I think you did that
it
shit.
It becomes a technique.
She definitely did that shit.
Yeah.
She definitely did that shit.
Yeah, that's the thing that I got out of that show. It's just like everybody on is just a total piece of shit.
Yeah, it's horrible
like
shit.
That whole big cat industry.
What they do to those fucking animals
people.
Is fucking horrible, man.
Yeah.
It's fucking horrible. I hate this shit.
Well, it's funny, too, is like Joe Rogan had a stand-up special a couple years before that where he did a whole bit about that, like how he's like, I don't know if y'all are gonna believe this or not, but there's more tigers in captivity in Texas than there is in the wild.
Yep, that's fucked
and up. Like he just did it as a joke, but then like two years later, like that documentary comes out and you're like, oh well, that's a huge fucking chunk of them right there is like those three farms
or
whatever you want to call them. Prisons.
Wasn't
tiger jails.
Joe Exotic's one in Oklahoma, though. I don't know if it's Texas that's true.
I've been there. Yeah.
It's horrible shit.
Yeah.
No, they didn't look happy.
Of course they're not fucking happy.
Yeah.
They say that a grown adult tiger needs, per tiger, like 400 fucking acres.
Yeah.
And these motherfuckers had like...
And they live in jungles.
Yeah.
So it's like, you know, Oklahoma's not a jungle.
No.
There's,
it's like the most opposite of jungle that you could possibly get.
Yeah.
Other than like a desert.
Yeah. Weather-wise, vegetation, fucking fauna, everything. Totally different.
The flora, the fauna.
The flora,
it's all
the fauna.
The flora and the fauna.
Crème fraîche.
Crème fraîche.
Crème fraîche.
My muse. My flame.
Gross.
My muse.
Gross. Gross. What's up, puppy dog?
She grabbed at my face.
This dog is such a sweetie. He wanted to eat me at first, and he like he is obsessed with me now.
Yeah.
Oh, what's up, puppy? I like you. We can be friends. You fit right here. He's definitely a fan of the if I fits, I sits. He's definitely a fan of that. And even if I don't fits, I'm gonna go ahead and
try to make it fits.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then if he fits, he sits.
Yeah.
Oh, is that your dog not on a leash?
Fucking Karen, goddamn. Shut the fuck up.
That's Mobility Mary.
Dude, that...
It's
that,
a lady on a scooter that just fucking bitches at everyone.
She has a GoPro.
Yeah.
And then she just rides around on her motor scooter and basically harasses people.
Yeah, if people are like walking down the sidewalk and she's trying to get by, she's like, quit blocking the sidewalk. She's fucking... Oh.
What?
I'm covered with scars from dogs.
That was...
What the fuck are you doing to them? I've been around dogs.
Me
I've
too.
Loved dogs
I don't have
my
any
entire
scars
life.
From
them. I don't have.
And I horse around with dogs.
Yeah, I'll fight with them.
Yeah, me
yeah,
too.
Yeah, I'll play fight real hard
me
with dogs.
Too.
And I don't have any scars from
I'll
dogs.
I'll put my arm in a dog's mouth, like my forearm
yeah.
in a dog's mouth.
Yeah.
Like, yeah. I don't know. It's a weird dominant thing to keep them from. To stop biting me because like most
well,
dogs like when they
I think it's a
forearm.
Size thing because your forearm's so big they can't like
that's true
bite it's just
yeah.
it's just big
it's almost like a
mill which
what do they call those that they do for horses a bit I guess
yeah what's up buddy you
kind of holds
the
mouth
what are you doing this guy is all up in my business it's fine
Melvin
so I saw something the other day if we're getting to the end if
we
need
should
wrap
probably
this
wrap
shit
it
up
relatively
okay.
soon yeah
all right
almost 2.5 hours
yeah
yeah man
whatever.
Video for a third of it
yeah man
it
was a good eye.
If anybody gets anything out of this it's I would say it's kill your masters
yeah
listen to Run the
Start
Jewels
over.
4 Yeah.
Yeah, I like that idea yeah. too. I need to listen to that.
Stop canceling art. Stop banning
yeah.
art, no matter
and
if you disagree.
And comedy.
And comedy. Stop trying to control
yeah.
thought.
We need comedy more than
we
anything.
Do. Absolutely.
Or not more than anything, but right now.
We need some shit like that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I...
We need it a lot, so...
I hope
give it
that...
To us.
And, mm-hmm. and I really hope that we've seen way too much where... Things like what's transpired in the past 2.5 weeks, you know, with the police brutality thing and all that, where there's been a blow up
yeah.
and then nothing has changed.
Yeah.
I really, really hope that we see some real legitimate change.
Me too.
Yeah, across the whole country as far as how our government chooses to police.
Yeah,
it's citizens because the way that it's doing it right now is not fucking working, and it's not good. Mm-hmm. It's not good for anybody. It's not good for the police. It's not good.
Yeah,
for the people in the communities that they're policing.
Yeah,
it's a no win situation.
Yeah, there needs to be more protecting and more serving.
Absolutely, absolutely. There's no need to respond to nonviolent crimes with violence.
Mm-hmm.
That I'll never understand.
That's why I don't really, that's why like riots to me, it's like when it's a situation, when violence triggered the situation, like why not respond in the same fashion?
Yeah.
I mean, if that's what it takes to bring awareness to everything, or if that's the trigger that freaking sets everybody off, it's like, you know, you almost kind of have to match the level.
Yeah, it's like maybe
of the catalyst
that
set everything off.
Absolutely.
So it's like, I get it. I mean, I'm definitely not against rioting by any means. I'm not even necessarily against looting. I just can't ever see myself doing it.
It's understandable.
So that makes me...
I get it. Not be able to relate.
Kind
of
against it, but I'm like, I get it. Like, do what you gotta do, but like, you know.
Yeah, those...
If I was in the situation, I would throw bricks. I would do stuff like
yeah,
that.
Smash cop cars. Yeah.
Those
J's ain't gonna help the movement out. Unless right. your shoes are worn out, then by all means, go grab some J's.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, shoes. It's a hole in the toe.
Okay, Billy, you need to.
You know what I figured
up
out?
Up that shoe game.
You know what I figured out?
What?
I got these at Walmart for $20.
You know what I figured out?
Huh.
So over the past couple of years, I've gotten really into sneakers.
Yeah.
I'm like 7 pairs of Jordans now.
Nice.
A pair of these guys, which I really love. These mm-hmm. Vans. These are a lot of fun.
Yeah.
I have a pair of Nikes that are like, it's like silk patchwork.
Nice.
Pretty cool.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I've developed another habit.
Yeah.
Of sneakers.
Yeah.
I've grown a love for sneakers over the past couple of years.
I do like a good new shoe.
like putting your foot in a nice new shoe. Smell the insole is
that
like still
smell of a
formed.
New shoe is something else.
It
man.
Is pretty nice.
That the glue and the fabric, give me that shoe glue.
Yeah, yeah. I for me, shoes are more utilitarian. It's just so I don't like poke my feet on rocks and shit.
I have work shoes that I don't spend any money. Like I wear these like jumper style boots, like side zip boots for work every day.
Yeah.
And I'll buy a pair on Amazon for like $30.
Yeah.
Because they're work shoes. But I like having nicer looking shoes to wear.
Yeah. I wouldn't mind having a couple pairs, but I think there's been a couple times in my life where I had a couple pairs of shoes to pick from and I just end up wearing the same pair every day.
Yeah.
Yeah. I just,
that does happen. And probably because you're like, oh man, I kind of want to keep these pairs nice.
Yeah.
And not
or it's like, out. I also like a shoe when it starts breaking in a little bit and the insole does start kind of molding to your foot.
Yeah,
a little
for
bit.
Sure. Cause those brand new shoes are uncomfortable. You walk around in them for like 3 hours and like, fuck my fucking feet, hurt, man.
Like all the sides of your feet are rubbing raw and shit. Yeah. Yeah, I like broken in jeans and broken in shoes. Mm.
Yeah, broken in jeans are great. The first day wearing a pair of jeans out of the wash is terrible.
Yeah.
It's the worst. But also like the fifth day of wearing a pair of jeans without washing them is terrible too because they fall off your ass.
Yeah. They lose all their
Get the sweet spot.
Yeah. That 2-3 day mark is real nice. And after that, it gets a little sketchy.
See, I pretty much just wear jeans until I get a massive hole like this, and then I buy like 2 or 3 more pairs, and then those last me for another couple of years.
You just need to know how to learn how to patch shit up.
I thought about
learn how to sew,
that.
Buddy.
Yeah.
Be like, a seamstress.
Because I mean, or the rest of these are fine.
Seamster. Seamster.
Yeah. Yeah. You can say stress. Seamstress.
Seamstress.
What's that? It's assuming my gender.
Is a seamstress.
Well, am I wrong?
No, you're not. I'm a seamster.
Boy.
Yeah.
All right.
Well, that's. I think we should wrap this up.
Yeah. Okay. Thanks for letting
me episode.
Come and.
Yeah, dude. Thank you for
alienate your entire audience at some point.
No. Honestly,
I appreciate you making the trip from Austin.
Yeah, exactly.
It's a It's nice to talk with the environment that we're in. It's better to talk with people in person than to do it over some sort of device or some sort of,
for sure.
And so I enjoy this shit. It's and it's been, you know, it's always good to see both of you.
I've intentionally kind of been trying to avoid this whole topic. Because it's sort of...
Because of your delicate, waspy sensibilities.
Yeah. Yeah.
That whack.
I'm just having trouble, like...
Articulating.
Putting my thoughts into words.
Yeah. And that's fine. But the only way you do that, I think, is kind of talking and getting perspective.
When you kind of have to talk to people that know you, in my experience.
Right. And know who you are as a person and aren't going to sit there and jump down your throat because you make a tiny little,
you on one little thing.
A fucking 3 sentence. What the fuck is that?
I don't know.
That was weird.
That was weird.
Oh, you hit
it's
that.
Telling us to.
I leaned on the keyboard.
I think it's telling us to shut this down.
Yeah, he's like, all right, guys.
That's enough.
Yeah.
It's the wrap it up, B.
Yeah. Anyways.
No, yeah. This
very fun.
Been a good time.
Thank you.
We'll have to come back.
Absolutely.
Come back.
Yeah. No, y'all, I told y'all, y'all need to come down to Austin and we can do an episode with Phil.
That would be awesome.
I think y'all would like Phil.
Continental Breakfast Club Southern Region Tour.
Or we could do a big old episode and get Eric and Phil. Yeah.
That would be fun.
And have some nice big round table discussions and stuff.
That would be
I think
good.
That's always fun.
Yeah. I'm down. I'm definitely down.
Yeah, that'd be super fun.
This is a good time.
I know. It's always a good time on the TCBC.
Email us at thecontinentalbreakfastclub@gmail.com or slide into our DMs. We're the Continental Breakfast Club on Instagram, Twitter. Thanks for listening.
Sploosh.
We love you.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.